frigid armpit of America. This is the Drunken Peasants Podcast with Ben and TJ, bringing you opinions of the news from an altered perspective.
Fuck it!
Hey, man. You got a joint? No, not on me, man.
I don't have facts to back this up.
It'd be a lot cooler if you did.
What the fuck you talking about, atheist?
It's okay.
You're nothing, okay. KJ. You're garbage.
Okay. I just want to be alive.
You're garbage.
And now, here are your hosts, Ben and TJ.
We'll do it live.
We'll do it live. Fuck it. Do it live. Fucking thing sucks.
Hello. Welcome to a special edition of the Drunken Peasants Podcast.
Oh, yeah.
Just kill us now.
Tommy. All Sotomayor.
You demanded it, and we are delivering an all Tommy Sotomayor episode of DP. Here it is, motherfuckers.
It's going to be painful.
I'm not looking forward to this.
Full of pain.
Just hours of Tommy's bullshit.
I sat down today and tried to imagine what this was going to be like, and I have a feeling I didn't get even anywhere in the neighborhood of how bad it's going to be. Like, this is all Tommy. Oh,
know,
God.
Man. I'm hoping that by the end of this, we'll understand Tommy better.
No. You think
no, we're not.
Dude, all we're going to feel is unrelenting pain.
We'll just understand what we already know about Tommy better, which is that yeah. He's shifty and a piece of shit and a liar.
Maybe we'll find...
At his core, I know that the truth about Tommy is he's just a scammer. That's really what the truth of Tommy is.
Yeah.
Like, it's all about the dollar.
Maybe we'll find some redeeming character traits.
I mean, you never know.
All right, here's the first video we're going to watch, fairly recent. It's called Why All Women Are Better Than Sistas, and he spells it Sistas. All right, so here it is. Actually, this isn't fairly
recent.
What up,
everybody? Since I'm in the car and I'm driving, it's about time to do another episode of Tommy Ponders.
I'm glad he dumped that idea.
That's funny.
He dumped that idea. Tommy Ponders.
Tommy Pondering.
It sounds like
there should be Paul Ponders. It's even alliteration, dude. Paul Ponders in a car. It could be you and Dinah driving around San Antonio. Paul Ponders.
It sounds like the name of a character in a Brett Keane novel or something. Tommy Ponders.
Tommy Ponders.
Back home now. My daughter looks cute. I love the fact that they all have on their little private school high knee socks.
This sounds dirty.
Yeah. He's talking about his daughter, he just said?
His daughter goes to a private school, and he likes the you know, the
I
way
like
they
the
have
way
to
dress. She dresses.
Yeah.
Like, whoa, Tommy.
And their little one-piece dress skirts. It's black and white. That's the colors of, like, a navy blue and white.
All right.
And I love taking my daughter into class. I don't do like the other parents. You know, you drop them off in the front and they take them on to class. Not me. Not me.
Is he playing a Nelly song?
I don't know what he's playing.
What a great parent Tommy is. Most parents just, there you go, son. Go off to school. Tommy's got to walk his daughters right into the classroom. Like, look.
He even sits down in the desk next to them and fucking helps them with their fucking homework, which is why they failed out of school.
So I can hit on one of them cute classmates in them little thigh-high stockings, you know what I mean? And that one-piece dress skirt.
You know.
Yeah. That navy color, they look real good.
They look good. They look real good up in that school. You know what I'm saying?
I walk my daughter to class. We eat breakfast. She usually don't ever eat it, and we just spend money.
So wait, you walk to class and then eat breakfast? All right.
Okay.
All right, rock on.
We eat breakfast. And we walk into class.
Right. Gotcha. You just said that.
Tommy Ponders.
Tommy Ponders.
I want Paul Ponders to be a show now. Just Paul driving around San Antonio.
Paul driving around
with Dinor and just, you know.
You gotta try to think. Just think of like four things you want to say and just say them. Just rephrase them over and over again.
Yeah.
Now I want to know, has anybody else with children? Men or women wanted to fuck or just thought about it, they child's teacher.
I'm sure. How transparent you are, Tommy.
Some people have, I'm sure.
You know, you
I hope
she, teacher
I hope she
didn't want to fuck her.
I hope she ain't watching this video, man. That'd be pretty uncomfortable.
But
teacher's like, oh, that's Celeste's dad or whatever. And you fucking go to watch, what? What the hell is going on?
Because I don't even know if she's seeing this video. She probably will.
She's probably going to see it, and you're still making this?
Yeah, like, she's probably going to see this video that I want to fuck her real bad. It's like,
let me just tell y'all,
Tommy.
I just want to fuck the shit out of my daughter's teacher, y'all. And she probably going to see this video even.
Kicks out my stuff. So she, I'm exposing myself to her. Now I wouldn't do it.
You almost said you're exposing yourself to her.
Yeah.
That's what you're hoping is going to happen.
Yeah, that doesn't happen until later, Tommy. But that's probably not going to happen at all. Well, this is old, so I'm assuming that I could say just in past tense, this did not happen for you.
Something tells me this whole thing is wishful thinking, though, because I think in Tommy's brain, this is somehow endearing to a woman.
Yeah.
A guy makes a YouTube video to hundreds of thousands of people and tells them he wants to fuck her.
Yeah, and he's playing some romantic music in the background, too, you know?
He's clearly trying to set the mood.
He should light some candles up in the car and shit.
He needs some, like, light dimming to make it nice.
He should have made this video at dusk, you know?
Get a nice bubble bath, some Cristal on ice.
Get his Barry White going on.
Fuck yeah.
Let's get it on.
But I be wanting to fuck my daughter's teacher. I don't know if anybody else has wanted to fuck their son or daughter's teacher, mother's a man or a woman. I'm sure it has. I'm sure you do. That's why I love going to PTA now. This white bitch is fine. Now, she's not fine as far as shape-wise. She got a shitty shape. I saw her shape, and I couldn't tell what the fuck was going on. The white women have pretty bad-ass shapes. They just do. They're shaped like a rhombus and shit. It's not just cute like that. You don't fuck a white woman because of the way she's shaped, usually.
You don't fuck a white woman because of the way she's shaped. This explains that explains so many of the fucking interracial couples I've seen. You know that? It really does. It really does.
But not only do I ponder, have anybody else thought about sleep with their teach? But I want to throw a caveat in there. Has anybody ever thought that maybe white women are considered more?
I just noticed Tommy's fucking fingers are like goddamn sausages, dude.
Yeah.
Yeah, they are.
And look at the size of his fucking fingernails. Jesus.
Dude, fucking Tommy can just kill you with one of his fucking fingernails. They're just burrowing into your fucking neck and just like sever your fucking carotid artery.
His hand looks like a fucking gnarled tree branch, dude.
Like, I think it's pretty funny that, like, during Tommy videos, we always end up noticing things that aren't really pertinent to the video. Because I think your brain just immediately, like, once you've heard about 15 seconds of a Tommy video, you know what the whole video is going to be. So you're just like, well, let's look elsewhere in this video for my entertainment.
Yeah. What kind of car is he driving?
You know what? There's always these, like, his videos are full of, like, a disproportionate number of little things that you notice like that, though.
They are, like, there's a cowboy hat in his back seat.
Yeah. Like, I've seen so many of his videos, and, like, I've never noticed until now that his hands are, like, freakishly large.
Women, because they're less aggressive than other women. I sit there and look at my daughter's teacher like this. When she be talking, because she's so nice, and she's so sweet. And even the black teachers, though, they're not that nice. It doesn't come across that way.
Yeah, why can't she be sweet like you? The guy who fucking said you want to fuck her and that she isn't shaped good.
Yeah.
And knows she's going to see it.
And of course, it just goes back to the oldest of Tommy Thane's. These black women, man. Let me just tell you something about black women.
Let me tell you something about these black bitches. They ain't got shit on this white bitch I want to fuck.
She's so nice.
She looks like a fucking sack of potatoes.
A rhombus.
Goddamn, she is white.
She's a rhombus.
She's a rhombus. Well, I don't.
Y'all better strap in, because I have a feeling we're going to be hearing a lot about how bad black women are today.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
They come across like them Olympian chicks that even though they're trying to talk sweet and nice and soft, boom! That's how they got to talk. Just like that.
Okay.
Damn, I too have noticed these observations.
Yeah. Those Olympian... Did he say those Olympian chicks?
Yeah.
What?
I don't know, dude.
I don't know.
You expect me to translate this?
Fucking Jackie fuck Joyner Kersee, man. That
hopefully,
bitch.
Hopefully by the end of this, we'll understand Tommy well enough to know what he means.
So, Do y'all think that the reason white women are considered more beautiful is because men like soft shit? We just do. We like feminine features, feminine faces.
Black, there's no black women with feminine features.
Nope, according to him,
faces.
No.
What?
They're all just dogs. Vicious dogs want to take your money and take your kids.
Feminine voices, non-aggressive movements.
Non-aggressive movements?
What?
Some people like aggressive movements.
You black women walk around like guns and knives, just like acting aggressive, like, come here.
The black bitch, stay still, everybody. The black bitch's vision is based on movement. She aggressive.
I want to make a gif of like the kids like hiding in Jurassic Park and have some like black woman just like moving her head around. You know, the kids like
And black women have aggressive movements. I'm telling you, I've dated half-breeds and white women.
Half-breeds.
Dark-skinned women.
Mudbloods.
Yeah, the
mudbloods.
I know,
it could have been that for some reason. Maybe I'm just attracted to ugly dark-skinned women. I mean, y'all tell me. But I've never, ever, ever had any one of my...
Hold on. If you're attracted to dark-skinned women, how are they ugly to you?
He says he's only attracted to ugly dark-skinned... I mean, yeah, it's like... it doesn't make any sense. If you're attracted to them, then
they're not ugly.
Not to you, anyway.
Yeah, right.
They're aggressive,
it's
though.
A perceptual... I don't understand.
Dude, Tommy doesn't make any sense.
It's like, all the food I like tastes like shit to me, dog.
Exactly.
Oh, it's nasty, but I love it.
I love the shittiest music, too, man. Can't get enough of that shit. Dude, maybe... Sit around and listen to it all day, but it sucks.
It fucking sucks, but I love that shit.
Maybe Tommy just likes to suffer.
Maybe he just views them as like a guilty pleasure, you know?
Yeah.
Like, you know, ugly-ass black women. I mean, I know they ugly, but... You know, honestly, something about it just get my dick hard. I don't know.
Ugly-ass black women are like tacos from Jack in the Box. You know what
Dude,
I mean?
I had some of those recently, you know.
Ugh.
I think I sent you a picture.
You did.
You know, TJ, that's like one of the nasty fast food items. I actually agree with you on. I do like Jack in the Box tacos.
They are pretty good, dude. I mean, like, even though...
No, objectively, they're not good. They're not good.
Well, yeah, you're right. They're not good at all.
They're, like, really low quality.
So that's how, like, the way we feel about Jack in the Box tacos is how he feels about black women.
Or like a hamburger from Del Taco, too.
Yeah.
Tacos from Jack in the Box and hamburgers from Del Taco.
I've never had anyone of my friends say when I was dating a dark-skinned girl, man, your girl's very beautiful. I've never been out on a date with my dark-skinned girls and had somebody at the restaurant say, that's a beautiful woman you meet.
So, basically what you're saying is you're looking for other people to validate your choices in women.
Yeah.
Like, it's not enough that I like this bitch. If other people ain't saying they like her too, fuck this.
Well, Tommy's all show, dude. I mean, look at every video he's done.
That's true. He's always trying to show off all of his shit, like...
Look at my garage.
Look at my garage. Look at my pool. Look at it. Look at my house. Look at my kitchen. Look at my fridge. Look at this. Look at that. Look at my clothes. Look at my car. Look at... So, I mean, I guess you're right.
You know what'd be really great? If someone, like, really rich just made a video to Tommy and, like, their
that
mansion.
That must suck for him because it's, like, this contradiction in his mind where the women that he's attracted to are not conventionally pretty, so he doesn't get compliments from other people. Wow.
I remember when he made his first video.
He needs them compliments.
He made his first video response to you. He was like, I could buy a girlfriend, sir. Do you remember when he said that?
Yeah, it's like, okay, well.
It's like anyone with enough money can buy a girlfriend.
Yeah, like,
is that
who's
cool?
Impressed by that? I
mean, yeah.
Yeah. It's not.
Every time I've been out with a light-skinned chick, somebody stopped me. Man, your girl fine. She don't have no ass, no titties, no nothing.
I gotta be honest with you. I am impressed by Tommy's wealth, but only because he gets it making videos like this. I don't understand it. Like, I do not understand how a man like this could get people to give him a dollar, much less 100,000 of them, unaccountable dollars.
But Paul, you have to understand that basically Tommy is just like living like this is all just show. Tommy doesn't have
I know.
Even if you give Tommy $100,000, we could legitimately do an experiment. Like, Tommy, we're gonna give you $100,000. We just gotta have receipts for everything you bought, and it would just be like stupid shit. Like, Tommy bought, you know, $10,000 worth of like Nutter Butters or something. Tommy bought new rims and they got repoed already. You know, just be stupid fucking shit that Tommy doesn't need. And it like, I understand what you're saying. Like, the con itself is like, how does he keep conning people? But it's like, look, right. It's just Tommy, he just finds a new angle to his scam. That's what it is.
What I think is perplexing to, like, Paul, correct me if I'm wrong, is it's like, how does someone that's this boring and ineloquent and just, like, a moron, basically. Like, how does anyone listen to this? Like, it's not entertaining. Even if you're a dipshit yourself, like, you can find smarter, more eloquent people to deliver your bullshit to you.
But Tommy is definitely tapping into some vein. He really is. There's probably a vein there, something we don't really realize.
He gets it from two sides. He gets it from, like, self-hating blacks, and then he gets it from white racists.
There you go.
I mean, like...
He tapped into, like, a group of, like, black people that want to hear about how bad black people are.
Right.
And then he got the surprise, like, white racist demographic to come in behind it.
I mean, we're going to play a video of him on David Duke's show later on.
There you go.
So, I mean, that just shows that he appeals to that audience. I mean, why would David Duke invite him to come on his show?
Oh, yeah, and I've even said it. I'm like, there's a lot of white people that just love Tommy because, like, Tommy's, like, the black guy that validates all their beliefs about black people.
You know what's kind of weird, though? He also had Farrakhan and seemed to get along with him. Well, Farrakhan, in many ways, is a black supremacist.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, so, but this is like the contradictory nature of Tommy, though, too. It's like, he can criticize black people, but if you attack him as a white person, he immediately plays the race card on you.
Yeah.
Of course.
So it's like he wants to have everything both ways.
He wants to have his cake and eat it too.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I've had other couples walk up to my girl and say, man, you're fine.
All right, I think we've done squeezed all the juice out of
so
this one.
The next video is called Blacks Don't Like Blacks, So Why Should Anyone Else?
Fair point.
Whoa, what's up, everybody? I want to say I'm officially done with black folks.
He said this so many times.
Black folks will never get anywhere in this country or any other one, but especially here in the United States, because we too stupid, we too ignorant, and we got too much self-hate. Today I
put up... Wait, what? I'm sorry, what was that last one? I mean, holy shit. This is like, can you add not enough self-awareness to that list, please? Fuck.
Yeah.
Jesus.
A photo of a man.
We just talked about what he thrives on.
I mean, but he's sitting here right now saying, like, black people too stupid, they're too ignorant,
and then too much,
and they too much self-hate. Look at that. Like, what?
Look at the shirt in the background. Black boys rock. It's like,
God.
The cognitive dissonance that makes up
Tommy.
You're
not even walking a tightrope between two positions. You just literally are walking in both positions at once.
You're like doing the splits between two positions.
Woo. Dark-skinned man. And I'm going to show you this guy. I'm going to put up his photo, and then I'm going to show you the comments. I'm going to tell you the comments that I got on my fan page. And those of you who are fans at Your World, My Views on Facebook, you saw this. You see this going on currently. Here's the photo first off.
All right.
Okay.
Now, after post...
Wait, was that Lewin?
Posting this photo on my... Facebook fan page. Well, of course it goes to my Twitter. Well, the first person to comment on my Twitter feed was a black woman, and her handle is Follow Back Promo, and her response was fucking ugly as hell. I would kill myself if I was that skin color. Number one, this is why I hate you niggas, because you sit around and you spell this and that, and you're too fucking stupid to even spell out your fucking words when you're talking.
Well, when you're typing, you mean?
Yeah.
When you're talking. He's critiquing Ebonics, and then he goes, you too stupid to even spell out the words when you're talking.
Yeah, yeah. Wow.
Dude, it's just like, really, the line, it's just Tommy, just, it sums a lot up. And that's every time when he does some shit like this, I'm like, it's just Tommy.
How many are you just trying to, like, we need a contradiction counter up on the screen.
Bing, bing. He'll be going off nonstop. Bing, 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 the whole episode would just bing, be bing, 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 bing.
You wouldn't even be able to hear him talk over the fucking bing, bings, dude.
It's full of this. And then there's this other motherfucker, this other black dude.
This other motherfucker.
Let's get Samuel to fucking redub your videos. This other motherfucker. You know, it's like, come on, Tommy. You're definitely guilty of this.
Bunch of ineloquent, foul-mouthed motherfucking cunts.
Yeah.
I like his shirt on the back. It says, I'm not a dad because what I did. I'm a dad because what I do. Yeah, you're such a great dad. Constantly yeah. talking about how black women are ugly and stupid.
In front of your own kids,
while
too.
You have a, while you're raising a black daughter. Well, luckily you're not raising her anymore, so that's good. We can be grateful to whatever woman was unfortunate enough to fucking take your seed within her that she realized the error of her ways and moved on.
Tony Brown. Now, Tony Brown posted on my page, Moses probably was this color, who knows, and true that. Seemed like he was agreeing with the post, because let me put the caption that I put over the guy's photo. I put, on earth we call this a man with this skin color every name but a child of God. In heaven, they call the man with this skin color God. 54 people are...
Well, that's a stupid caption.
Yeah.
Yeah.
As of now, I have thumbs in
the caption.
Yeah. Those,
it looks like a guy from, like, Africa to me,
yeah.
You know?
Yeah, I captioned this, God would call a man of this skin color a color, but here on Earth, we call this skin color a God.
What the fuck? I don't get it.
Oh, it was just... People giving sympathy because Tommy. Nobody likes dark-skinned people. I know that from living 36 years. Nobody likes dark-skinned people. I get it.
You're but not it as dark as the guy you showed the picture of. Put it up on my page
for my dark-skinned people. Well, after Tony said what he said, which I thought was...
I mean, you're the one who doesn't like dark-skinned people. You open this video by saying that black people are stupid, ignorant, self-loathing, which apparently I mean, you are.
He's so race-obsessed that he, like, breaks down the different shades of black people.
Yeah, dude.
Oh, man.
Like lighter-skinned black people are more attractive and, you know, get more out of life. Than like the darker skinned people, they're like oppressed and people think they're ugly.
The darker your skin, the greater your sin.
You know, Tommy's fairly dark and he seems to do just fine scamming people. So yeah, what the fuck does he have to complain about?
Nice. Well, it shows you when people share your photo. So I went and looked to see what Tony had shared when he shared his photo. This is what he put on his page. I was gonna say, dang, that. There we go again with that D-A-T, stupid motherfuckers. That nigga black. All I see is he so black, he looks like a spoiled mummy unwrapped. But I'm not going to say it. All I'm going to say is that we're all God's children. Children
minute,
of God. Jesus, no matter what.
I love shit like that.
That is fool.
I love when people good. Say, I'm not going to say he looks like a fucking spoiled mummy, but he looks like a spoiled mummy. It's like, you just said it.
Oh, I love it.
Who completely wrote out something and then said, but I'm not going to say it. So here's what I wrote back to that dude. I said, dude, why would you say something that insulting about the man after coming to my page acting like, you know, you like the picture? He put, he said, first off, I didn't say nothing insulting. Second off, what? Did I say anything insulting? No, I clearly said that I was going to say it, but I didn't make fun of him.
You
of
did
anyone.
Say it.
Wow, you can't. No, that doesn't. Yeah, I gotta side with Tommy on this one. That yeah. don't make any fucking
Me
sense.
Me too. Me too.
I mean you can't be like, you know, I mean, let me tell you something. I was gonna call you a stupid faggot and threaten to smash your head in with a brick, but I ain't gonna do that. It's like, you yeah. just fucking did that. What? I ain't saying he looked like a mummy. I'm just saying that I almost said he looked like a mummy.
And I think that, you know,
and
it's
I think
like,
he does.
Okay.
Hey, Ben, I was gonna say that your mama is a nasty swamp hog bitch, but I ain't gonna say that.
You ain't gonna say that.
Oh, okay. It's all good.
It's all good, because he ain't saying that.
All right, so I responded back to him, and I said, cool. So I'll say this. I was gonna say you look like a gay-ass dude on your photo with some retarded-looking kids in your hand, but I'm not gonna say that. I'm just gonna say we all God's children.
Why the fuck? What was it? What was the necessity of going after the kids in his hand, dude?
Yeah.
I love that Tommy's trying to weave holy rolling into this fucking racist screed of, like, what the fuck?
Hold on. He's all over the fucking map, dude.
Didn't he just admit that?
All over the map.
Did he just admit that he, like, insulted someone's kids that were, like,
As he's fucking saying, like, don't judge this guy, but fuck your kids.
Hold on. Isn't that the reason he gave for flagging our videos? Because we, like, talked about his kid? Like he claimed that we like mentioned his daughter. And
yeah,
that
he did say that.
Yeah, what a fucking hypocrite.
Well,
we didn't even talk about his actual kid. We made like a hypothetical.
No, we asked him how he would feel. You know, because he was on. He was making a video saying like, "I support. You know, slavery was a choice for black people." And we're like, "Okay, so." Would you think it was a choice if, like, your daughter was a slave
right.
and, like, they were threatening to fucking rape her and kill her if you didn't do what they said? I mean, and he's like, you insulted my daughter. You talk about my family. It's like, no, we were trying to give you a hypothetical scenario, you stupid shit.
Right. So look at what he's doing now. He has a problem with some dude on Twitter and decides to insult his children.
But not only that,
hide behind their family.
This whole thing is Tommy is trying to admonish this guy for daring to prejudge this dude that he posted a picture of, yet he's going to attack this guy's kids who did nothing to him. So, I mean, it's just, he's just all over the fucking place. There's no consistency of thought. Fucking consistency of any fucking thing.
The operative thing that we've learned here is that if it's possible, the people that watch Tommy are even dumber than he is.
Yeah.
And that's about it.
I mean, I think in a sense it is intentional, too, that Tommy is all over the map. I mean, I think part of it's just because he's stupid. And I think the other part of it is just, like, he knows. God, you're annoying. It's so hard to pin someone down when they have a million different positions. Because Tommy's, oh, I never said that. I said this. Because he can then just go back and cherry-pick his position.
It's like the Trump. It's the Trump factor, dude. Like, because Trump, depending on where he is, he can sound like he's a hawk. He can sound like he's an isolationist. And both sides hear that and say, yeah, Trump is like me.
Oh yeah, Tommy.
He's talking on both sides.
Tommy definitely knows how to play to an audience.
I think Ben wanted to say something.
Oh, go ahead.
Oh, I was just gonna say that Tommy. Fuck, dude, I'm so high. I can't even remember what I was gonna say.
Oh shit.
It's probably for the best, Ben.
Yeah, probably.
But he went off on me. How dare you say that about me and my kids? First off, I ain't gay, and for you to talk about some kids and say they look retarded, I said, sir. But I didn't say it. I said I was gonna say it, just like you just said.
Okay. It was wrong when he did it. It's still wrong when you do it. I know you're trying to make a point. I guess I see what you're trying to do there, but
it's wrong when the other person does it, not when he does it.
Dude, what Tommy always does is when he wants to get uppity with somebody, he's always like, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, let me explain something to you. It's like, no, Tommy, you're a fucking shitster. You've always been a shitster, and don't act like, you know, you have the fucking high ground in this, where it's like, oh, well, you know, it's like, yeah, the guy said something stupid, but instead of keeping the high ground which you had, you just wouldn't stoop to his level, so you're a fucking moron.
Man, this dude over here, he raped his grandma. So to show him how fucked up it was, I went and raped his grandma, too.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah.
Your little post wasn't offensive. Then another black dude wrote up here.
Fair enough. Yeah.
Brandon B. Jones. B. Jones Jones. That's a dumbass nickname. It's Brandon B. Jones Jones. You can call it self-hate all
you
want.
Okay, so don't judge people based on their skin color. Judging them by their name, that's fine. Judging their kids because they said something kind of snotty on the internet, that's fine. But don't judge them by their skin color unless you're Tommy, in which case it's totally fine to judge people by their skin color also.
Right,
so.
Yeah.
That's the message. We're just boiling it all down to its essence so everyone understands where we are here.
Dat. There we go again with dat. Dat motherfucker is hideous. He don't even look like he from this, D-I-S, planet. This nigga is not black. This nigga is native blue.
These comments are kind of funny, honestly.
They are. They're great. I mean, I am also annoyed when people use this and that, but I mean, yeah. Like...
But you notice how they were saying motherfucker, too.
Yeah, I mean, like, this is how... I mean, black people are just typing like they talk, so whatever, you know? I mean, I don't give a shit.
Yeah, I mean, they can fucking talk however the fuck they want. Who
yeah, unless
cares?
It's
Who
like
cares?
Some, like, actual document.
Yeah.
Like, whatever.
Is this an official government contract or something, or a document or something? No, then who? I don't fucking care how someone talks. It's their
yeah, it's
business.
Like, when I see them write dis or dat, I know what the fuck they're saying. It's not like I'm confused. Like, what? Huh?
Huh?
Again, black folks. These are black people talking about a black person.
So are you.
Yeah.
Yeah, people of all races talk shit. It tends to happen.
I mean, like,
we just watched a video of him calling black women violent, angry wildebeests and shit.
If I posted some, like, super albino motherfucker on Facebook and wrote the similar caption of what you said, some gibberish about, this is what people look like in heaven, I guarantee there'd be white people looking like, man, that's one ugly fucking powder-looking son of a bitch. I wouldn't be like, man, how you gonna talk that way about a fellow white person, Tommy?
You've betrayed us.
Yeah, not everything boils down to race, Tommy. I know in your mind it does. Who knows what you really fucking think, but it really doesn't.
It's not even race. It's like sub-races within a race. It's like lighter-skinned people.
Well, he's extrapolated so far.
I know. Well, the thing is like a lot of these comments are, you know, black people in the United States, and there's usually not people as dark in the U.S. as there are in Africa.
Yeah, sure.
You know? So, like, some people do have a reaction to that, because, like, many of them probably haven't even seen people that dark.
That was a pretty black motherfucker.
Yeah.
Oh, sure.
That's because there's no chance that guy's ancestry mixed with non-black people, more than likely.
I mean, you know? Like, how much blacker could that dude have gotten?
No.
I think the answer is none.
None.
None blacker.
I love that comment. Like, he ain't black. He navy blue. That's fucking awesome.
Navy blue.
He navy blue.
This is why I cannot stand you niggas. You American niggas are ignorant.
Okay, so let's.
That's kind of what I mean.
I mean, you just
kind of what I just said.
You just said like, you people judging a man by the color of his skin. I cannot stand you niggas. Like what?
Yeah.
Like, how do you, in your mind, how do you not see?
It's the fucking cognitive dissonance of Tommy. It's like, he'll, on one hand, decry racism, and the next hand, embrace it.
Just like that dumb bitch, Dina Jacobs, sat there in front of Crystalline and said, you know, I have more refined features than you because my mother's very light-skinned. These motherfuckers are ignorant. You America.
But you just said that in your last video that we just watched. That was exactly your argument.
Yeah,
and now someone else is saying it, so it's ridiculous.
Who else but Tommy?
Oh my God,
he's also a TJ.
Yeah,
he is.
Yeah,
black women are so ignorant that I put up a video of Shania.
He's a loud
girl
motherfucker
killed,
on the internet.
And y'all
he's like Bizarro
thumbs down
TJ.
That video because you don't like me. So a memorial video for a 5-year-old that was murdered, you dumbass bitches thumbs down that too, because you don't like me. And you punk-ass niggas is sitting around with hypnotic in your hand on a fucking photo in your bathroom.
Okay, I'm Scott. What does it matter if they thumb down a video? Like, do you think they're, that like, does that, like, send the 5-year-old soul to hell or something?
This video got too many dislikes to hell.
You're basically saying, like, you know, if I say something, you know, people got to give it a thumbs up. You know, because I put this little dead kid in it. Now you got to like it.
Dude, you've made videos. I'm sorry to interrupt you, Paul, but like TJ's literally made videos that were like for charities, for people who like need clean water. And that's where all, and the money went directly to them. The money, TJ never saw a cent of the money. It all goes 100% to the charity. They get all the money. And the water campaign is actually funded by angel investors. So, like, all of the money goes to the wells. And people have downvoted that video. And like, fuck you, TJ. You're a scammer. This is bullshit. You know, fuck this video and fuck with this charity. And, like, they were actually literally trying to, like, they were writing the webmaster of, like, the water, who owns, like, or manages the water's, like, actual official website. It's like, is this a real charity? Is this a real website? So, I mean, if you have people who are willing to do that for TJ trying to raise money for people that need clean water, what does Tommy expect? If people don't like you, they will try to take you down no matter what.
Yeah, bunch of faggots.
How the nerd to talk about this and that. I can't stand you niggas. I hate you niggas. Every last one of you. God. This and that. You run around spelling like this shit in public. You run around talking and typing like you talk. Ignorant son of a bitches. Didn't want to sit up here and just give this man all kind of hell about how ugly he is. I hope every time a white person walk past every one of y'all motherfuckers, they talk about how black and ugly and monkey like you look. And you better not say
Jesus
shit
Christ.
Because all y'all do is spend your time talking about another nigga. Fuck y'all.
Dude,
I can see so many fucking white racists watching this like, yep.
Oh, dude.
He's one of the few good ones,
I can imagine. I can imagine the really racist white people just like sitting there just watching this and just being like, I ain't going to say it often, but this fucking nigga's a genius, you know, like... I can really see why white racists embrace Tommy now. I mean, like, he just went on this fucking rant. This just obscene fucking rant where he just, like, at the same time is saying, like, don't be like this. He's just doing the exact same thing he's saying you shouldn't be.
Like, yeah, I mean...
How can he not even realize it?
I'm floored by the hypocrisy of that last statement. All y'all doing is standing around talking about another nigga. That's what you do. That's what your channel is.
The lack of self-awareness hour continues. I am done. It's time for a civil war where blacks and niggas square off.
Oh my god.
We have to get rid of the niggas. Wait, niggas with a Z? After you were just complaining about people writing diss and that?
Oh my god.
In order for the black race to rise up, at TJ Sotomayor.
Who is TJ?
How is he not able to... I don't even... I don't even know. I don't even fucking know, Tommy. I don't even fucking know, dude.
I'm sorry. That is a pretty ugly motherfucker. It's not even just because of the skin either. It's just, you know, like, I don't know. It just ain't good facial features or anything.
Yeah, people look different in different parts of the world.
Yeah, people look weird in other parts of the world.
All right, this one's called Stop Going to the Club Broke. Don't buy women drinks at clubs.
Part one.
Part one.
Oh, man. So Tommy bought a lot of drinks.
What's up, everybody? What's going on? I saw a video today. A woman sent me this video about this man, and she wanted my opinion. The man said,
cue terrible music.
Stop, he was giving a message out to all men. Stop buying women drinks at the club. So here's my response to the brother.
That's an important message.
Stop being broke at the motherfucking club. Stop going to the club with no money. Why a nigga gonna complain about some shit like that? Don't buy a woman a drink. Why you gotta make this big ass to-do list and tell the whole world to don't buy women drinks? How does that make you feel?
Tommy, this is the kind of shit that if you came up with it, you'd be sitting there defending it.
Yep.
Yep.
I could easily see you fucking even coming around in this position on your own and thinking it was your idea later on.
Yeah, but Tommy needs to feel like better. Like to him, it's like they broke motherfuckers and Tommy is just rolling high. So I don't give a shit. I ever want a drink. You know, I'm Tommy. Which, you know, I could see Tommy having that personality at like a bar or someplace. He wants to look like big brother. So he's like, yeah, I'll buy this round. You know what I mean? Just so he looks good.
That doesn't make you. That don't make any sense. That's like me saying, stop paying rent.
What? No, it's not.
No, that's the worst analogy I've ever fucking heard.
You could go to a bar or nightclub and buy no one but yourself drinks. It's not really necessary to buy other people drinks unless you want to.
If it's paying somebody's rent and they profiting off of it, why would you put out this big edict for everybody to not pay somebody's rent?
It's not an edict.
What?
What?
It's just some guy's opinion, Tommy. It's not a fucking... This is an edict. You know, like, you know, once this goes out, you have to follow this rule. It's like, no, it's just someone's opinion.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure the guy you're referring to has no actual power to stop people from buying women drinks.
Yeah, nor has that fucking proclamation work.
Now I understand if it was something that makes some sense, but how does this hurt you or anybody else? How is buying a woman a drink hurting
them? So it's time.
Them?
It's it now. Now it's we've hurting. Gone into the Tommy Sotomayor recycle phase where he's going to... talk about the video from three different angles that all mean the same thing.
Or are completely contradictory to one another.
Right.
You, because you don't have no motherfucking money, so you should stop going to the club. Or be man enough not to buy no drink, but you ain't got to tell the world not do it because your ass can't do it. Nigga go to the club broke as a motherfucker. You don't y'all hate when a nigga go to the club like that? Now ain't nothing wrong. He the type of nigga, let me tell you this. He the type of nigga go to the club, you know, he gotta make sure he be there on time. Motherfucker club start at 10, this nigga at 9:30, make sure he get there before the motherfucking line ain't free no more at 12. You know that dude. There ain't nothing wrong.
I know that dude.
I don't know that dude.
I'm all about them the club, you know?
Yeah, you even made a song about it.
Up in the club, yeah.
With being that dude. Ain't nothing wrong, because, I mean, they charging 30, 40, 50, sometimes $100 at the door. You...
Jesus.
Wow, $100 at the door for a club? Holy
shit.
Yeah,
what kind of clubs are you going to?
Fuck that.
Apparently black people are really stupid about this club shit.
Yeah, it better be like raining booze from the ceiling.
But man, like every fucking time I listen to a fucking rap song, like literally, like, the line up into club has been in almost, like, 80% of rap songs for the last 10 years. Like, I listen to new shit all the time, because me and Chelsea play this game where we'll fucking look at the latest music videos and we'll watch them all to see which one's the worst, because there's never anything actually good. But I still hear that line, up in the club, up in, and it's, you know, ah. So they're really all about this club shit.
Club. You don't want to go in that
Fuck
way.
The club.
But I'm bougie like that. Me and my daughter go to the mall. I don't park myself. I pay the valet because I can.
Damn, Tommy. You impressed. Damn, you fucking, are so fucking impressive, Tommy.
Tommy don't fucking park his car like a commoner. He goes to the valet like, valet, yeah. Take my vehicle.
You are so fucking impressive, dude. I don't even know how a man gets as fucking awesome. You fucking valet park your car? That shit's fucking awesome, dude.
Paul, you go to, like, you know, a place, you know, like, let's say you go to, like, an amusement park, Paul. You do the valet, yeah. or do you do a self-parking?
Never. I don't think I've ever used a valet for any, but, the, you know, I just was, like, I was raised, like, why am I going to pay this motherfucker $20 to park my car? I could just park my own car. But, you know, once again, thanks to all of the generous donators to Tommy Sotomayor's various projects so that he can fucking valet park his shitty fucking car at the mall.
Yeah.
I would hate to watch a nigga come out talking about some don't pay the valet, park your own car.
You don't have to listen to them. You can still do what you want. You can still fucking, you can still like, valet you know, park. You can be like, fuck you, nigga, I'm gonna do what I want.
Yeah, you can be like, dude, I like valet parking. I don't mind paying $30 every time I park, so I don't have to fucking, like, you know, go and park my own car. It's your money, Tommy. What? Well, actually, it's other people's money, but I guess they gave it to you, so it is yours.
I don't understand what world using the valet at a mall is impressive in.
It's like, not Tommy's like, world, dude.
Sorry, guys. I'm a little late. I had to chat with the valet.
I'd probably just look at you like you were nuts, dude. Like, okay, Paul, you know, you valet parked.
This KFC doesn't have a valet.
Drive on.
Fuck this place.
Drive on.
Who are you? Because you broke?
Okay, you don't have to be broke to not want to use the valet. Like, there's plenty of people who have the money to afford valet. They just don't do it because they think it's a waste of fucking money.
Yeah, park your own car.
And they just want to park their own car. Walk.
Yeah, unless it, like, really simplifies your day to valet, like, I wouldn't do it.
I mean, unless, like, the nearest parking spot is, like, way the fuck far away.
Like, and, you know what? Like, when we went to, like, Universal, we, like, valet parked. But it was just because...
Yeah,
because
then you could just be right there at the entrance. You don't have to fucking walk through, like, a million miles of bullshit.
Yeah, exactly. That's when it makes sense. But just at the mall, like, dude, you're going to walk around the mall anyways.
Don't tip the waitress more than 12%. Who are you?
Don't tip the waitress more than 12%? Who the fuck's saying that?
That's like that's a black stereotype.
Yeah. Actually, I have heard people who I'd known who were like waiters and waitresses say black people are terrible tippers.
Anecdotal evidence.
No! What you're saying makes no sense! Broke people always want to put out some edict to tell other people to be broke. Like there's some virtue in being broke.
Look, I really doubt that's why the guy was saying it. I really doubt it was just like, save money. It was probably more just like, you shouldn't do this because, you know, this is not going to help you pick up women. You're just going to look desperate or something.
Yeah, I mean, like, have you noticed he's not, like, we're not even seeing the thing he's responding to at all. He's not, like, showing it to us. He's not summarizing it at all. He basically just tells us, like, one little simple fact about, this guy said don't buy drinks, and then he responds.
Yeah, why did he say that?
Like, we don't know anything about this dude's reasoning or anything.
I hate that. Nigga said, you told me today, you conceded. Nigga, if you had it, you'd do it too. Only reason you telling people not to do it is because you don't have it. That's your lot in life, nigga, to buy a drink. You're not handsome. You can't go to the club and get away without buying no motherfucking drink. Then if you buying somebody's girlfriend a drink, that means you're a dumbass. Now, everybody got a lot in life.
I guarantee he's done that.
If you're a simp, you're a simp. Play the game. Old men know they got to pay young women to fuck them. That's how it works. What an old man. What it look like you got somebody like Hugh Hefner running around talking about some don't pay young women to fuck you. Nigga, fuck you. Why would you tell somebody how to spend their damn money on somebody else because you don't have the money to spend?
Tommy, just what do you care? Like... Even if this is, like, the attitude they're taking, like, what does it matter? Like, it doesn't affect you. You could still do all the things you want to do. You can still spend your money however you want to spend it.
Because this displeases Tommy.
Why do you care so much about what other people think? Like, other people... Why other people got to have different sensibilities than me? What the fuck is wrong with them? Like...
This is just another thinly veiled excuse for fucking Tommy to brag about how rich he is to people.
Yeah. Oh, of course.
Which is a common running theme in these videos.
Let's see. Like, I wish I had, like, a list in front. I could write down, like, all the Tommy tropes. Like,
yeah.
Bragging about his wealth and possessions.
And showing it off.
Like, showing it off, yeah. And then black women are shit. Yep. Black people in general are shit. But also, if anyone's attacking him...
White liberals.
You know, then they're racist against him. You know, and slavery was a choice, but whatever. I don't know.
Yeah, slavery was a choice, guys. Come on.
This is not a recurring
these
one.
These niggas like this, this is your lot in life. You're not a handsome fella. You gotta pay a couple drinks. It evens this shit out. I know I'm not a 10. Shit evens itself out. Now, I don't pay to get in the club. I'm a cheapskate. I don't pay to get...
What?
I don't even know.
You just... How are you... You just said you don't... What?
The more we watch, this other shoe almost always just drops in a Tommy video where he's just all like, man, you know what? I fucking always spend all kinds of money. I ain't a 10. You know, I got to spend money, but I don't pay shit to get in the club. It's like, what?
Because I'm a cheapskate. It's like, what? No, you're not. You just said you paid for valet parking at the fucking mall. You just said that you gotta buy drinks for women, and you fucking admonish someone for fucking saying otherwise. And you just said these broke people don't mean to tell us how to. But didn't you fucking? Like, personally, I don't pay to get a club. I'm a cheapskate. What?
I don't know, man.
What? I mean, like, I couldn't write you. I couldn't fucking write you as a character, dude. Because you just gotta fucking like. You're like constantly just building a house of cards and then knocking it down and saying yeah. Like, hey, look, it's a masterpiece. What?
Look, I ain't paid to get in the club since I'm 25. But I had to pay to get in the club because everybody I know own a club. Or I'm invited to be at the club.
Wait, did you say everyone you know owns a club? Everybody I know owns a club? What? Every single person you know owns a fucking club?
He only associates himself with club owners.
Yeah. Okay.
What the
Everyone
fuck?
Everyone I know owns a club.
Yeah. I'm dumbfounded.
What the fuck, Tommy?
Can you imagine, like, everyone I knew owned a club? Like, my grandma, you know, she's, like, 93.
How well do you have to know
them? She owns a club.
How well do you have to know them before they own a club? Like, I'm assuming, like, you know...
My 12-year-old nephew owns a club.
The clerk at the gas station I kind of talk to sometime, you know, does he own a club?
Hey, grandmama, where you going?
When he gets off at the Exxon, does he go to his fucking club?
Yeah. Grandmama, where you going? I'm heading out to the club to make sure these bitches are shaking their asses. When your granddaddy get back from his club, tell him to call my club because I need to talk to him about club business. What the fuck is going on in this world of this, dude?
Everyone I know owns a club.
So it's been free. So I can do that. But nigga, you can't. Don't nobody know you. You paying to get in the club. So if that's your lot in life, then play your fucking position. It's too many
niggas. He's claiming that, like, when Tommy Sotomayor strolls up to the club knows Tommy, and they're like, nah, come on in, Tommy. That's what he's claiming.
You ain't got to pay shit.
Why would Tommy have to pay?
Your money's no good here, Tommy.
Open up that velvet rope. Come on in, Tommy.
Tommy, I demand a video of you.
Only six bitches tonight. Oh, okay, bring them on in.
Tommy, they open the velvet rope. That thing's like, when they see Tommy's fucking limo roll up, it's done. They're pushing people back. Like, oh, sir, Tommy's here.
Dude, he gets the whole VIP suite and everything.
Now, Tommy strolls up to the club, tosses keys to the bouncer. He's like, park that shit for me, nigga.
Yeah.
Bust on in there.
I don't think Tommy could secure himself a complimentary small fry at a McDonald's, much less... Entrevue at any fucking club.
What are you talking about? Actually, I think Tommy actually has litter bearers. I don't think Tommy even walks into the VIP section of the club. He's carried.
I think they throw rose petals at his feet. Like,
like bands are playing. America, Tommy is here. You know, like, it's just great. When Tommy shows up at the club, it's just a fucking, it's a new world. The club just changes.
The second Tommy walks in the club, every head turns, you know? And all the fine-ass bitches on the dance floor just, like, push the men they're dancing with away, like, fuck you, nigga, Tommy's here now.
Tommy's here.
And they all be grinding up on Tommy, you know?
Tommy's all like, oh, you know, Tommy's having his assistant choose which ones are coming in with him tonight. That one, that one, that one, that one, and that one.
He just got money.
Niggas don't want to pay their position. Play their position. Everybody can't be Michael Jordan.
Like Tommy.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody can't be Michael Jordan like me. You got to live with your lot in life, nigga. You know? Your bitch ass got to buy drinks. I don't got to buy no drinks for no bitch because I'm a perfect fucking 10. I'm a beautiful man.
That's the whole deal. Nigga be Steve Kerr. You still can win. You still get a ring. But now.
A ring? Okay.
Oh, nigga want to get on the internet and hate. Don't buy bitches drinks at the club, and I'm the woman hater?
Dude, I fucking promise you we could search through Tommy's videos and find a video where he says, don't buy women drinks in the club.
Yeah, I ain't gonna buy no nappy-headed bitch, no fucking drink, and no
stinking-ass
club.
I guarantee it. Yeah. I guarantee it exists. I promise you it's out there.
All right, you want to do the next one?
Sure.
This one's called White Women Are the Standard of Beauty, So Black Need Weaves to Compare or Compete.
Really, bitch?
Really, bitch?
Okay.
Oh, shit. Yeah.
Hello, America. I'm Tommy Sotomayor.
I just noticed Tommy has not aged really great.
Yeah, I mean, it's he's looking rougher and rougher as the years go by.
Yeah, dude.
Having to buy more drinks at them clubs.
Yep.
Probably his concentrated paranoia and stress, too.
Now, I put up a video earlier. And that video was of a white woman describing weaves and how white women don't wear them. She doesn't know anybody who would do that. In the process, I was reading the comments. And you know I like reading the comments. I love reading you guys' comments, actually. And while reading your comments, I was... I'm forced now to discuss something that people said was of issue. And as you saw the title, it is that white women are the standard of beauty, and that is why black women get weaves. So let's go ahead and...
Are white women really the standard of fucking beauty? I mean, there's plenty
of... To some people.
I mean, sure, but there's plenty of fucking women in our culture who are considered, like, the height of attractiveness that are not fucking white.
Yep.
Yeah.
There's tons of them. There's tons of fucking Latinas and black women
Asians.
And Asian women and Indian women and sons, all of them. There's tons of them. Like, you know, I mean, it's not like every fucking woman you see that's hot is fucking white.
No.
I mean, what about fucking Beyonce? What about the every fucking Kardashian that has fucking 7 million followers on Instagram and all this shit? I mean, they're not, it's not all white bitches, okay?
Start off with an admission. I admit that white women are the standard of beauty. I admit that when you wake up in the morning, if you look over and you see a white woman, it is almost like you just woke up in the bed with God and you got to...
Tommy, you coming from a fucked up place, dude.
Yeah.
Coming from a real
you next to
fucked
God.
Up place.
Like, okay, Tommy.
I mean, like, and it's the funny thing is, you know, you can just roll over and be next to, like, the fucking, like, a land whale fucking bitch.
She white?
Fucking cellulite and fucking varicose veins.
Is she white?
Oh, yeah, she white.
Oh, she's God.
Damn.
She's God, dude.
It's like laying in bed with God.
Laying in bed with God.
Look into heaven every time you look at this white woman. So we're gonna agree with black women that
her titties sag down to her knees, but she white, she divine.
White women are the standard of beauty, and that is why they are trying to copy white women. Now that we're going to admit this, there are a few other things that we must admit. Let's see if they admit this. Number one, that dispels the myth that black women are strong. See, if white people's standard of beauty is going to make them spend $300 and $400 on their hair per session, is going to make them tie up their...
Tommy, you literally live your life based on trying to impress everyone around you. So you don't have any room to talk about, man, all these bitches giving in a peer pressure and shit. Like, no, that's you, bitch. In your last video, you were just complaining about this shit.
I mean, like, how many black dudes live, you know, in your neighborhood near the golf course and shit, dude? Do you think you're, like, trying to conform to white culture in some ways? I mean...
No, it's different when he do it.
Oh, okay.
You guys have never heard all those rap songs about golfing and how they live on the golf course? You guys have never heard all that?
Dude, I want to make a rap song about golfing now just because you said that.
It's like...
Okay.
Oh, but you know, when black women try to have, like, long, straight hair, that they're just, like, trying to be like white women. But when he does white things, it doesn't fucking matter.
No, it's fine. It's Tommy. All right.
To put someone else's hair on their head, then that kind of shows you that that group of women are not strong.
No, that really doesn't show that.
Weaves?
Where's the correlation?
Weaves are not... I don't even consider, like, a weave trying to look white. I mean, that's, it doesn't look like white women hair.
No. It looks like their hair only longer.
Right.
Like, it's, what?
Yeah, I don't... Okay,
I mean, strong women would be strong in their beliefs, strong in their looks, strong in their value systems, strong in who they are.
I honestly think it looks nice when a black woman has, like, her hair natural.
Strong in their...
Like, the...
Their looks? I mean... Okay.
More Tommy nonsense.
I don't even know what that's supposed to mean.
Number one. Number two, black women will say that they wear weaves to make black men happy. Black men... That myth has been dispelled also with them saying white women are the standard of beauty. Because guess who they're trying to please? Not you. See?
I'm sure that most black women who get weaves think it's because, like, they look good.
Yeah.
It's because they think it looks good. Their fucking friends probably think it looks good.
No.
Dude, the early parts of Sotomayor fatigue syndrome are setting in on me. Like,
oh, you got a long way to go, buddy.
I know. The constant position reversals and contradictions and weirdness is just like...
You can't get a foothold in there, man.
Oh, dude, my head's been spinning the entire time
I'm
watching
this. Next video. The truth behind what makes Tommy Sotomayor bash black women.
Finally, the truth.
Oh, why? You are, though. Come on, Tommy. You are.
He's wearing a Montreal Expos shirt.
What's going on, everyone?
That's a baseball team that doesn't exist anymore.
Your boy, Tommy Sotomayor. And I want to talk to you
He's
about
something.
He's
playing, like, 80s.
This sounds like it'd be in a fucking John Hughes movie or some shit.
Is there a
dude.
Fireplace in the background?
It's
or
an
that
actual
fan?
Song.
Yeah. That's an actual... Is Molly Ringwald going to dance with the nerd at the school dance soon or something?
I remember one time he talked about Depeche Mode, too, so he must like that kind of music.
Why are you listening to white people music?
Yeah,
Tommy? Is that because you're trying to conform
Dude,
to
Depeche
white
Mode
culture?
Depeche Mode is totally white people music.
Oh, God, yeah. Yeah, you don't see too many men. Man, you hear that new Depeche Mode, nigga?
Man, that shit have me hungry like the wolf, nigga.
Yeah.
A lot of you may have not... heard the announcement or remember the announcement, and there was a very special announcement that was made. There have been accusations going around saying that...
God, I just want to sing in a whiny British voice to this music. Turn around! You know, it's just such an 80s anthem.
Isn't it like, hey now, don't dream it's over? Isn't that the song?
No, it's not. It's not that. No, it's just a generic, I don't even think it's an act, I think it's just a generic Lounge Lizard 80s kind of, like,
it
anybody that
exactly
sang in a
like
snooty,
it.
Husky, well, hold on, let's play it again, let me listen.
Okay.
Mother and my daughter and my aunts, the accusations that were out there were...
I don't think so either.
That they were black, and they were female. Now, for a while, I tried to deny these accusations, as I know what would happen if people found out that my daughter and my mother and her mother were black.
If they found out that your daughter and your mother were black?
Let me think.
It doesn't really take much sleuthing, dude. I mean, I'm kind of just like, you know that black guy? Pretty sure that any children he has are going to be black. Pretty sure that his parents were black.
I remember the one time he was playing The Doors. Do you remember that?
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right.
It would immediately invalidate anything I'm saying because, as we all know, having a black mother or a black aunt or a black sister or even black...
You know, it actually is refreshing that he actually messed around with, like, camera angles and shit for this. Like, at least there's some editing going on. That's neat. That's better than just recording it in your car, I guess.
Yeah, I guess. Friends.
Means that you know of an individual who is the greatest thing in the world.
Situation.
Because to know black is to know perfection. And to know black female is to know goddess. So I messed up and I tried to hide this secret and I've been outed. What's happened lately is I understand why no one would listen to me now. Because how could you listen to someone with a black mother, black
aunt, so this is kind of like a Tommy
sarcasm, I say.
This is Tommy's apology video.
I think he's being sarcastic.
No, I'm pretty sure you're right. I'm saying
bad
like,
about
it's like,
your
a,
citizens
like a apology.
Or about the country. No one would do that. I mean, if you're an American, there's no way you would talk bad about America, the country where you are.
Of course there
okay,
is.
Okay, so I see the point you're trying to make here. Let me explain you why it's stupid. You can't claim to be a good father when you have a black daughter and 90% of the videos on your channel are about how black women are shit, how they don't look as good, how they're fucking have no self-confidence, now they're all crazy, and so on and so forth.
Aggressive.
Yeah, they move too aggressive for you and all this other shit. Like, you can't possibly hold all that fucking, like, bigotry and outright real misogyny without it affecting the way you treat your fucking kids. And we've seen how you treat your kids because you've made videos where they're in the back seat and you're like, shut the fuck up,
be quiet.
I done told you, be quiet when daddy's making his rambling nonsense bullshit.
Yeah. Let me let the cat out.
Yeah, let me let the cat out.
Oh, wait.
Put it back in. Put it back in.
Bad.
What the fuck? He posted a video right before he got into a car accident, too.
Of course he did.
What an idiot.
That doesn't make any sense, so I understand why people are concerned. With a recent rash of videos that have come out as well, people have questioned why I bash black women. Now, I always wondered about this bashing term, and I hear it very often when you hear from black women. And maybe some black women can explain why they feel like speaking about them in any term that they deem negative is bashing.
Any term that they deem... Like, you literally, it's not up for interpretation, dude. It's not like you said something that might...
You unequivocally have made statements that can be considered and are obviously derogatory. It's not like we were sitting around debating what you like. What you mean. What does Tommy mean by that when he says black bitch is aggressive and, you know, just, you know, as soon as look at you, stab you. You know, like, what does that mean? It's like, Tommy, your meaning is clear.
Yeah, I mean, like, there's no obscurity about it. Nothing is vague about the shit you've said about black women. Like, you've been pretty damn clear. Like, if you're consistent on any one thing, it's your hatred of black women. So, I don't understand this fucking shit now where, like, they just want to construe every little thing as, you know, they perceive it as being negative. It's like, no, it is negative, you dipshit.
Is it over?
No, it's definitely not over.
Oh, hold on.
Oh, shit.
I'm going to explain this because I had a so-called doctor go in on me and say, I'm bashing black women, and I must have been hurt by black women.
Were they really doctors?
Let me explain.
I mean, like, I guess it depends.
It was an internet doctor.
Oh.
That
I'm an internet
true.
Doctor, too.
I have been hurt by black women. But then John Walsh had been hurt by a criminal. That's why he spent the rest of his life.
Oh, you're not John Walsh.
Oh, come on, dude.
Yeah.
So, his child was abducted and then decapitated. And
then he spent the rest of his life dedicated to finding criminals. Yeah. I mean,
that's not, I mean, like, that, it's not, whatever you've been through, I guarantee, is not comparable. Like, this bitch, you know, she act like she too good for me and she leave me. Man, I was hurt. It's like,
yep.
That's not even nearly equivalent, dude.
Nope.
It's not even in the same fucking ballpark. He's just warning the masses, TJ. Telling the people the truth.
Find the criminal. He didn't spend his life trying to find people who were doing things other than crimes. As a matter of fact, he turned it into an empire. There have been a lot of people who
Tommy really sat down and wrote this and thought that this would be a good angle for him to take. Yeah, man, I'll just paint myself as John Walsh, man. Because some black bitch I dated once was sucking some other guy's dick while we were still together. So I'm basically John Walsh. I could just, you know.
He's basically John Walsh.
Yeah. Pretty accurate, basically, you know, John Walsh.
John Walsh's kid lost his head. My wife was giving some guy head. You know. Yeah. It's head, equivalent. Head.
Holy shit.
Like Malcolm X. Malcolm X was hurt.
Who else is he gonna do?
He's like John Walsh and Malcolm X. He's like I'm both. Like,
he's John like Walsh X, dude.
Let's throw another one out there. I'm like General George Patton. Yes. You know, dogged in my pursuit of the enemy. I'm like Will Smith.
I'm black.
Yeah, Sid Hartha. The Buddha himself, Siddhartha. Yeah.
Siddhartha, God.
White supremacy. And so was Dr. Martin Luther King. And what they did was dedicate the rest of their lives.
I'll tell you what. They had very little in common in many ways. A few things in common, of course, but...
When I was hunting for people to make the joke with, I intentionally skipped Martin Luther King
because
I was like, nobody would make that. Nobody would.
He's not going to go right from Malcolm X to MLK, dude.
I think,
but he did.
Amazing, isn't it? But you hear people say, he must have been hurt, as if that's a bad thing. As a matter of fact, the majority of leaders against something were hurt by it.
You're not a leader.
Talk to a Jew.
You're not a leader against anything. You're an insane person that talks about how black women are inferior to white women. Like, you're not a leader.
No, he's the leader. He's the leader against black women, dude. Well, leading voice.
He's not against
the tyranny of black women.
He's not against black women. He's just trying to inform people.
I just thought of a comparison. You know, Martin Luther King filled the National Mall with people who wanted to hear his message. And Tommy Sotomayor walks around the mall and hopes somebody recognizes him. So...
And he gets valet parking before he does it.
Yes.
Just as MLK probably would have done.
Yes.
I wonder why they have so much against Germany. Or against the SS. Or against Nazism.
Maybe against
the SS,
dude,
or Nazism.
Maybe he is going to make the Patton reference, the dude. Make the Patton reference. Come on.
Dude, if he calls himself
Patton. It's strange
Patton.
That we, as grown
I think he's moving away from
cannot
it.
Admit that most people who have a problem and start a crusade against it are usually people affected by it because they understand it more intimately. So therefore, they do lead a crusade on it. Well, let's go back to this bashing. I was told by Dr. Watkins that I could achieve the same goal, and I'd love to debate him. I could achieve the same goal without bashing. So I'd ask him, have you achieved this goal? I'd ask him, has anyone achieved this goal that you claim that I'm searching for, that I can't achieve by bashing? And if you have, then please show us, because I wouldn't be able to look and see all the examples of where it is bad. To any of you people who are watching this, and especially the women, when you call it bashing, do you understand that everything that I talk about, I have stats to back it up? And
no, you don't.
No,
stop right there. You're a liar. You do not have stats back it up.
I got scientific evidence for everything I say.
First of all, most of your shit is just you ranting in a car or somewhere. So there's no stats to back up your shit. And also, like, you contradict yourself so much that you'd have to have contradictory fucking stats.
Those of you that are watching this on pay-per-view, feel free to screenshot this.
Oh, yeah.
Tommy.
Example after example after example from the real world.
Instead
of dealing with the issue, I'm still being told it's bashing. Now the question at that point has to be, why is bashing so bad? Because what we're considering bad...
Didn't he write you a message saying, you guys keep bashing me?
I don't know if he used the exact words bashing, but yeah.
Oh, well, he pretty much admitted as much when the DMCA. That's like, I didn't really like what you were saying about me.
Yeah, but then later on, he found out that we were, because we gave Tommy a few months to simmer down, and then we started attacking him again. And then it was like, he started messaging TJ.
Sorry, like, I thought we was cool now. It's like, no.
No, why would we be cool? You let
What happened that was going to make us cool?
You crippled our channel. You could have taken that away at any point.
Yeah, and you didn't. So, I mean, maybe if you'd taken it away and been like, you know what, I'm sorry I acted irrationally. You know,
I would have been fine with it.
I'd have been like, you know what, Tommy, thanks. It takes a big man to admit that, you know. But instead, you just waited for, you just fucking sat there, and we had to sit there and wait for a fucking 90 days or 30 days or however long it took.
Well, I remember we had our Joseph Martelli one, too, which was, like, for, like, 3 hours. Like, I'm DMCAing you guys. And we're like, okay, well, we're going to go after you then. And then it was gone. So Tommy could have taken it away at any time.
Yeah, so fuck him.
Oh, yeah. You could take a DMCA away at any point.
Oh, yeah.
Which, I mean, he admitted as much that his was not even a valid DMCA.
Now,
so
is when you take something that is considered a negative about some other person or group, and you expose it.
So you're like, you're countless a lot of times I'm being told, ad hominem attacks on people where you're just like, they're shit, they're stupid, fuck them, they deserve to die, whatever, you know, the bullshit that pops into your fucking mind. That's all, that's not bashing. That's like, you're really just telling it like it is. Come on, Tommy, you do bash people. You can say you're leading some crusade, but who the fuck is following you? Where's the fucking army of people saying the same fucking thing, Tommy? There's nobody. There's fucking you and a few, like, trolls on the internet are like, good job, Tommy. Here's some money for fuck those white liberals.
That the exposure of this problem is the problem. I've been told that my language is a problem. Yet I can do videos just like this one. Never yell, never cuss. And it'll be the exact same thing. As a matter of fact, there's no yelling, there's no cussing, there's no name calling in this video. I'm not going to hit anyone. And you will still get negative comments in the comments.
That'll be the next video where you go on an insane tirade against people. This is so, like, this is Tommy Sotomayor trying to make excuses for his shit content. And it's not working.
Oh, I'm buying it, dude. I'm buying this. I totally think this is legit.
Comment section. You will still get thumbs down from people, even though everyone makes a statement about this bashing.
Yeah, you're gonna get thumbs down. So fucking what? Who gives a shit? What does it matter if you get thumbs down? You know, you know what I do if I go to a video and I see, like, huh, more people thumbs down this than usual? I don't fucking do shit. I don't give
a fuck. Go ahead and thumbs down this video. I will ban you.
I won't ban anybody. I don't give a fuck. I just don't give a shit. Thumbs down it if you don't like it. I don't give a fuck. Why even? I mean, like, at a certain point, I just wonder why you're still watching, but.
All right, let's move on to the next one. Former Klan Grand Wizard Dr. David Duke interviews Tommy Sotomayor on his radio show.
Cool.
So I'm going to bring on Mr. TJ or Tommy Sotomayor. Welcome, Sotomayor, to the program.
Hey, how's it going, Dr. Duke?
It's going fine, and I...
David what the like, fuck is he a doctor of?
I don't know. He's a doctor of racistology, dude.
He looks positively pleased as punch to be meeting the Grand Dragon of the KKK.
I know.
He's such an... Like, what the fuck?
Dude, did you hear that giddy smile? Did you hear that giddy little note in David Duke's voice? Like, I can't believe I'm talking to a nigger.
I listened to your to a speech you gave out back of Bubba's garage one time talking
holy
about
shit.
Up
okay.
The niggers, and let me tell you, oh man.
So David Duke, I'm gonna read off his political party affiliation. So before 1975, he was affiliated with the American Nazi Party.
Cool.
And then 75 to 88, he was actually a Democrat because those were the actual Klan members back in the day. And then the Populist Party. And then from...
Then he became a Republican.
Yeah, then a Republican, and now he...
No, I mean, he's Republican from...
Then he was Reform Party. That must have been... That was Ross Perot.
No, he was Republican, and then he was Reform, and then he went back to Republican.
Yeah, and as Reform, though, wasn't Reform Ross Perot's party when he ran for president? Pretty sure. Let's
maybe?
Hold on. Let's see.
I bet Ross Jesse, Perot was
yes.
Overwhelmed
let's see.
With gratitude.
Jesse Ventura... Yeah. Perot, Buchanan, Nader, and Ventura were all Reform Party candidates.
Yeah. Well, it didn't really go anywhere.
David fucking Duke. What's he a PhD in? Louisiana State University, Baton Rouge. Integrational Academy of Personnel Management.
It says interregional. Academy of Personnel Management?
Yeah, I don't know.
What the fuck is that?
I don't know.
He has a PhD in personnel management?
I wanted to say thanks again for you sharing my talk on your show. I mean, you even brought up Nazi things Party. Such as the massive rapes of European-American women by mm-hmm. African-Americans and almost no rapes of black women by European-Americans, and how that black people should lessen this hatred and hopefully their violence, which is not only hurting European-Americans by the scores in this country, but also terribly hurting African-Americans, which is killing each other.
Mm-hmm. It says he was the Grand Wizard of the Knights of the Ku Klux Klan from 74 to 1980.
He's put it behind him now.
No, that's in the past, guys.
That's in the past. Come on.
So let's start with
that. I dabbled in Nazism for about 8 years, you know? Just no big deal. I was the Grand Wizard for 8 fucking years.
Yeah, I mean, I've been a Nazi. I've been a Klansman. I've been a Democrat. I've been a Reform Party. I've been a Republican. You know, I've been all over the map.
It's funny how he was a Nazi. That was like someone that, you know, killed the parents and grandparents of so many people that are still alive today. And, like, he was, like, on their side back then, but now he's still, like, someone that runs for political office and shit like that in Louisiana.
Yeah.
It's crazy. You know?
He's a nice guy. I actually lived in the same town as him.
If there was, like, an American, like, you know, ISIS party.
I knew where his house was. I, like, you could drive right by his house. Like, people would be like, that's David Duke's house right there.
Fuck.
Do you see the media in this country, the controlled media in this country, as something which is leading black people astray as to who the real enemies are and is causing a black behavior and inciting black behavior that is damaging not only to European Americans but to African Americans even more so? They kill each other. African Americans are killing each other, murdering each other in great roles because of this influence of the mass media. I'll start with that.
The mass media
has nothing to fucking do with that whatsoever.
Yes, they do, teacher.
They really do not.
Dude, the fucking mass media is just behind it all. Come on.
I mean, like, maybe the media stokes some racial tension fires ratings.
They definitely do that.
But if you're saying that's, like, an underlying cause of why that happens, that's just fucking retarded. It ain't like, I mean, like, I guarantee you if you fucking sit there and talk to, like, a bunch of thugs in the ghetto, you know, sitting out in front of the fucking, you know, little local shit store run by the, like, Asian people that are, like, willing to actually fucking put a business there, and they're all hanging out with their fucking guns tucked in their fucking waistbands and shit. I mean, they ain't gonna fucking, they ain't gonna tell you, like, you know, I was watching some CNN earlier, nigga. You know, won't believe the shit that's going on in this country.
You know what, man?
Let's go commit some crimes against each other.
I used to do good in school. I used to get good grades and stuff. But then I watched CNN, nigga, and it was like, click, clack. It's time to get out there in them streets and start shooting people. You know what I mean? MSNBC, nigga.
Rachel Maddow up in this bitch.
Damn.
Media right now is destroying black people more than anything else. You have situations now where blacks are killing each other, and it's a blip on the national media scale. But as soon as someone outside or so-called, they can make it seem like it's white people killing black people, then they will surely highlight that and put this quote-unquote fear in black people's eyes for the white man. And as I said once before, I don't walk around a crowd of white people in the United States and feel threatened. And I'm a black man, but I have walked around crowds of black males and felt threatened, even when I say something that they disagree with. Even when having you on my show, my life was threatened.
Well, I mean, it's one thing to, like, just be walking around and be threatened for no reason, but when you're having, like, someone who has known to be, like, the leader of racist organizations in the past, I'm sure you can expect that you're going to get some backlash at that point.
Yeah, I mean,
you do realize that you're a black man who is featuring videos of a grand dragon of the KKK, right? You're going to get a little backlash.
Former, Paul.
Oh, sorry, my bad.
Come on, Paul, let's be fair here. Former Grand Wizard.
By blacks. And one of the things that I'd never heard you bring up, but I wish you had, was because we spoke about it briefly about the Trayvon Martin situation. But what they didn't bring up was the fact that George Zimmerman had a Jewish and Hispanic ancestry, not a white.
Jews are considered white. Jews and Arabs are both part of what they would call like Semites, and that's considered part of the Caucasioid race.
Look,
I think the real issue was not Caucasus
Mountain Range.
Was not that. It was the fact that George Zimmerman basically followed Trayvon Martin, got into an altercation with him, and Trayvon Martin ended up being shot and killed. I think that's the real issue.
Did the media kind of frame Zimmerman as a white guy, especially early on?
Yes. Yeah. I mean, the name sounds like it could be Jewish or it could be German, you know?
Like, I think it's kind of interesting that guy has gotten in like hot water for violent outbursts like three times.
Exactly.
Since.
Numerous times. The guy is clearly a fucking hothead. I mean, that's obvious.
And before he had been arrested for being violent prior, cops.
But we're supposed to believe that he was the victim, though.
And then he decided he wanted to he decided he wanted to play like cops and robbers in real life, even though he wasn't a real cop, and chase people around the neighborhood.
The funny thing is about it, with the laws in Florida, is that even though he pretty much instigated everything and was the cause for everything, like, and he started getting the shit beat out of him because he had a gun, he was in the right, you know, like, even though I'm totally the cause of everything here, and if I had just minded my own fucking business, none of this need happen, but because I did that, and I'm getting assaulted, now I have, like, the legal right to kill somebody.
Yep. Yeah, that's the precedent that was set.
And you don't have to have no duty to retreat.
Yeah, I can start a fight with whoever I want. Yeah. As long as I have a gun, I can just blow them away once they start kicking my ass. Be like, you know, fucking Brock Lesnar is in Florida. I'll be like, hey, Brock, fuck you, and deck him right in the face. And when he comes to me, I just blow his ass away. Be like, I was threatened, man. You see Brock Lesnar, he tears people apart, man.
Yeah, my life could have been ended, man. I could have been dead.
Yeah.
Had to do what I had to do, man. Stand your fucking ground.
He's going to take me to Suplex City, man.
Yeah, and he would, man. So, you know.
I kind of feel like a real-life suplex actually would fuck you up.
Oh, yeah.
Yes,
dude.
It would, by him, too. I mean, like, they do suplexes in collegiate wrestling. I mean, that's a pretty common move because you grab the guy from behind and just, like, throw them over like that.
Yeah, well, he does it pretty well.
Yeah.
Ancestry, but he was referred to as a white man.
Sure, exactly. I brought that out in my video, and we didn't talk about it. with so many things we could talk about on our program. But you're right; he was a mixed race. If Zimmerman was a white guy, and I've got a picture of his grandfather, about as black as the Ace of Spades, mm-hmm. blacker than you, my friend.
The Ace of Spades.
then if he is a white man, then why don't they talk about Barack Obama as a white man?
Okay, well, no one still says that Zimmerman's a white man. That was, like, some early coverage kind of framed it that way.
I would say, like, you know, Obama's equally white as he is black, but the thing is that, you know, his black features show much more prominently than his white features.
Okay,
so.
If you were sitting down, if you were just sitting down, you had no idea who Barack Obama was,
and he walked into a
restaurant, and you'd be like, that's a black guy. You wouldn't immediately say that's a white
you
guy.
You know, there are, like... Yeah, I've met some half white, half black people that looked way more white than Obama, for sure.
Sure.
So it just depends on the genetics, which traits end up passing on.
Mm-hmm. That's true.
Right?
Right. And I referred to him as a white man. I'm like, why is it that when they have a mixed race child, they give that child to the black community? That's another aspect.
It just depends on how they look.
They don't give it to the black community. I mean, like, it just, you know, people are going to look at Barack Obama as black. Like, the second he was going to school and shit, everyone's going to see him as a black kid. I mean, it's not like it's being given to him. It's just that he happens to be, like, when you're white, you're fucking pretty much white. You know, the second you start to have any sort of African features, you're considered black. That's just how people's minds work. It's not some fucking social scheme against you or some shit.
Used to destroy black people, to have them completely mixed to where you can be as white as you or as dark as me and still consider yourself black, which is causing a major confusion.
As white as David Duke? No.
Yeah.
There's no one as white as David Duke that's considered black.
No, there isn't.
No one.
Rachel Dolezal, dude.
Even she was darker. And she
was that the fake black woman?
And she was she got herself tanned and shit and did everything she could to look black.
Yeah.
She should have just said, I'm transracial.
Transracial. She did say she identified as black, so I guess that was transracial.
But they black people didn't want to identify her as black, though.
No.
They're like, nope. Wrong, bitch. You white. Get out of here.
Is probably, I'd say, in the top five of most damaging things that happen to black people.
And you believe, and you, I heard you state just the other day, I saw one of your videos, and you talked about this on my show, that it's...
How stupid is David Duke that he's watching, he's actually sat and watched Tommy Sotomayor videos and thinks that Tommy Sotomayor is worth having as a guest on his show? Like, I'm almost thinking, like, you guys are saying, like, I can't believe Tommy would talk to David Duke. I can't believe David Duke would fucking talk to Tommy, dude.
But who the fuck is David Duke these days?
Dude, No. Tommy serves such a good fucking role for David Duke. Here's a black dude that's willing to come on and talk all this racist shit that he talks about blacks.
But you could find black dudes that are racist against black people that are way more eloquent and well-spoken than Tommy. I've seen them. I mean, he's just still an idiot. There's no way around it. He's just fucking dumb. He can't even find his way through a fucking coherent thought.
But Tommy's
If you're David Duke and you want to parade a black man out in front of your audience that's going to parrot everything you say, do you want eloquent and intelligent? Or do you want Tommy Sotomayor, who's just going to go, yup, 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 yup?
I guess that's true.
It's very normal and natural and healthy for people to want their children to look like them. They look like their mothers and fathers and grandmothers and grandfathers. It's the most natural thing in the world.
Yes.
But the Zionist media has demonized that natural...
There's the anti-Semitism right there.
The Zionist media has
fucking
demonized
Zionist
it.
Media, man.
I've never seen... Show me
the
anything...
The Zionist media.
Show me anything that demonizes two white people getting together and having white kids. And I've yet to see that.
And how is it like...
It's demonized.
And how is it like linked to like Israel or Judaism or anything like that?
Well, look, man, they just, you know, they fund and control all the major news organizations.
See, that's those are his Nazi roots showing right there.
They just fund everything.
Yeah, and when, you know, when he...
Look at the entertainment industry, guys.
I remember
how many Jewish comedians are there.
A kid in my class did an interview with David Duke, actually, and we got to listen to it, and one of the things they asked him about was... Eli Wiesel's Night,
yeah.
And David Duke pronounced his name Eli Weasel.
Oh, my God. Really?
Yeah.
Weasel. He is a damn weasel.
So I heard recently, TJ, that you were considered an anti-Semite.
Oh, yeah. That's true. I was.
Well, he is, though.
I made the mistake of making a mild criticism of Israel.
There
like, truly mild. And the next thing I knew, kangaroo shit was being flung at
me. So why doesn't he block Tommy Sotomayor for having David Duke on his show?
Because
David Duke's anti-Israel?
I don't even know. Devin's probably not friends with Tommy anymore.
Oh, dude, he made comments one time about how, like, he didn't understand why you were fucking with Tommy.
Really? Well,
yeah.
I wonder if he stands by that when Tommy's having this, like, the Zionist media, because, you know, Devin thinks that Israel just can do no wrong.
They can't be
right. I mean, it
just
is
a saintly nation of fucking pure-hearted geniuses.
It isn't a very hostile region.
I mean, that's what I'm saying. Like, I mean,
like how did it get there? We should examine that for one thing. Like, how did it end up there?
Cause what
it,
are you saying, Ben? Are you saying Israel doesn't have a right to exist, Ben?
He is.
Oh God! The anti-Semitism.
Why is everyone?
What do you have
so
against
hostile?
The Jewish people, Ben?
Why you're anti-Jewish. Okay. It's disgusting. This is racism. This is the most disgusting racism I've ever seen.
Anyway, I blocked him again. I'll unblock him in a few days.
Oh, you keep running. Oh, baby, I'm sorry.
No, I just, like, I have to block Devin every once in a while because he just gets on my nerves.
Please forgive me.
I love Devin.
What I do. Please forgive me. I can't stop loving
you. Yeah, dude, you and fucking Devin are an off and on fucking couple, man.
I mean, we don't have any sort of actual friendship or anything.
Please forgive me.
But I just think he's interesting, but there's all...
You know what? We're not, like, serious or anything. I just think he's very interesting.
He's just a very interesting guy.
Oh, God, Devin.
Whatever.
I wish I knew how to quit you, Devin.
Why do I even say anything?
Preserve true, his or her heritage and be called a racist. To be called to act as if that is somehow unnatural, when that is the most natural thing that a human being could do. I remember in high school, and I had to have this discussion on my last show, when a girl was telling me, this is natural. It was a white girl who called in. She said, I have a black husband, and this is natural. And when you guys were saying it, and I said, hold on a minute. I said, do you remember your high school? I said, in high school or elementary or middle school, people didn't even know each other, but what naturally happened during lunchtime? The people naturally segregated themselves. There was no teacher. There was no faculty that told them, go segregate. Whenever you go in, you can go in any high school across America right now. You will see a natural segregation by the children.
That's true.
Yeah, that did happen in my high school.
True enough observation.
Exactly. Of course, this is all over the world. Every people, naturally, this is the most natural thing in the world. You know, it's like tribes.
And that's fine if they choose to do it themselves, but there shouldn't be any...
Yeah, there shouldn't be any, like, admonishment for... Like, I'm going to have a black girlfriend or whatever, you know, and not everyone did do. I mean, yeah, there was like the black kids tended to all cluster in some group of black kids, but there was definitely black people that hung out with the white kids and white kids hung out with the black people.
They're just using the appeal to nature fallacy. They're just going, hey, it's very natural. This is how things are supposed to be. If you don't follow this, then you're not being natural. It's like, who cares? Just because it's natural doesn't mean it's good or right or proper.
It's not even necessarily racism in that instance. Like, you're saying, like, racism is natural because people tend to hang out with other people from similar fucking cultural and ethnic backgrounds. That's not the case. That doesn't make you racist.
I wonder how David Duke would respond if Tommy Sotomayor told him how he exclusively wants to fuck white women. Like, I'm wondering if that comes up in this conversation.
Good point. Good point.
I doubt it.
I have a feeling that Dr. Duke wouldn't take too well to that little aspect of Tommy's personality. But
you want
to
sleep with the European what women?
Well, he's just getting the trashy ones. He's getting the leftovers.
Yeah, come on,
dude. With white women, it don't matter about the shape.
We just gave you a bunch of STDs. You got STDs?
Oh yeah, all over.
Evolution takes place when people migrate. Tribes obviously savor and love their own particular expression of humanity, and that's the true diversity of the world. And the evil ones are the ones that are trying to destroy these distinctions. These distinctions that mankind is not one; it is many. And when you destroy the diversity of mankind, you destroy really mankind himself and all the different expressions of mankind.
I'd rather have like ideological diversity and individual diversity than cultural diversity. Like, we're all beholden to our shitty ancient cultures that were irrational and stupid. Like, how is that good? Fuck that. I don't give a fuck what my ancestors did. They were morons.
Never mind the fact that people of different races procreating together is creating more diversity. It's creating more mixtures of people and more mixtures of ethnicity. It's just creating more.
No. So. It's destroying the original tribe, though, Paul. That cannot happen. Why? We do not know. Oh, because it's natural. Naturally, this is what happens, so naturally, this is what we should do.
If that's what naturally happens, then what do you even care? It'll just play out the way you want.
That's unnatural, though. When you mix it, it's unnatural.
White people don't pay too much attention to. We know the destructive nature of the Jewish control.
What the fuck is this music covering up their audio? This is terrible. All right, I'm moving on. All right, here's a trailer. It's about a minute long for Tommy's movie that he raised a bunch of money for that never actually happened. Fatherless Sweet. America trailer.
Why is it that
especially in the black community, the man has been marginalized to the point where he's not needed. He's only needed when it comes to knocking the woman up. After that, he's useless.
Okay, what about when the woman takes him to court and makes him pay child support?
I want to point out that this is really great framing of this shot.
Yeah, this is terrible.
I like how your eyes are nearly cut off there at the top. That's really great.
Why is he lying on a bed?
Let's check.
Yeah. He's someone. What is with the teenage girl writing in your diary position you're in right now?
Yeah. Yeah, are you going to, like, you need to throw a teddy bear in that shot and cuddle it a little bit and roll around playfully.
Why don't you put on some pink pajamas or something? I don't know.
You can blame. The kids grow up
and
to be bad.
And this is like B-roll. This is totally B-roll. Whatever. Yeah, this is not even a
good
shot.
Say he did it without him. He's a scapegoat. How can you raise a boy?
Okay, this isn't even, this is just, so he went and he bought like, probably like $200 or $300 worth of B-roll. Talked over it and said, "This is a trailer for my movie."
God, like, what a scammer, dude.
Oh my God, dude. What a piece of shit.
And have him have any confidence when the man who he looks like or who is responsible for half of his creation.
I can just see Tommy sitting there in the fucking buying the clips like, "Sad black boy."
Dude, his only
kid.
Contribution is a terribly framed him on the bed, like, "Hey guys, you know, this is fucked up."
Oh my goodness.
You hate and you villainize. Does no one find this odd? It's also funny that this is a conversation that a lot of America wants to have.
Man, it's so sad how this little black kid gotta sit there and mess around on his iPhone and shit, man.
No daddy anywhere to be found.
Ain't got no daddy nowhere. He just got an iPhone. That iPhone ain't gonna raise him.
That's all they had at B-roll.com, though. Was just a little kid on a cell phone, so.
I'll just play sad music over him. That'll make him seem sad.
We should do a trailer like this, TJ, just to show how ridiculous it is.
I could only afford Black Boy on iPhone and Black Boy by Fence. So we gotta stretch those two clips out.
Zoom in on it.
So why had anybody had it really deep before this?
A fatherless America. I didn't pay attention to a single fucking word he said.
That was not even a trailer. That was pitiful, Tommy.
That was a joke, dude.
That tells you nothing.
Please help me bring this film to reality. Donate by clicking the link in the description box or go to SotomayorTV.com.
So this is basically his pitch video, like, you know, hey guys, donate.
Like, what was that little ending part of the fucking Microsoft Movie Maker scrolling text not like a big tip off to people that maybe this is not the best guy?
Yeah, he doesn't really like his camera skills really don't seem like they're of cinematic quality to me. Unless his plan was just to buy a shitload of B-roll and talk over it, which that's probably what his plan was when he actually intended on making it, but then he realized like he wouldn't even have to make it, so he just didn't bother.
Let's see. The only part that he actually shot has half of his fucking head out of the shot, and he uses fucking Windows Movie Maker to put scroll titles at the end. Maybe not the guy. Nope. That's not the way it works, though. He got $100,000 for this piece of shit.
People are like, man, he gonna be the next Fellini. Dude, we gotta fucking fund this shit.
Wow. And how long ago was that posted, Ben?
It says 2015 in the it says A Fatherless America Trailer 2 2015, so I think that was the scheduled release date for the film, or maybe it was just the trailer in 2015.
I mean, I know it's been long enough now that people have called him and asked him, like, where the fuck is this movie? And he's just been like, I spent the money on child support, bitch. It's like, okay, well,
I mean, did anyone expect the movie to be made?
I love the irony of that.
I think the people who donated probably did.
Well, Tommy Sotomayor,
Tommy Sotomayor spent his fatherless America money on child support.
Yeah. Wow.
Yeah, that's pretty awesome, isn't it?
That's wonderful.
And then people gave money to fight white liberals.
Yeah.
Like another, like,
what's he been doing to fight white liberals? Was it fighting white liberals to show off the fucking... Yeah, showing off the hookers that you buy at the golf course house that you're renting. Like, holy shit.
Like I said, man, it's fucking Tommy, dude.
Man, he's
look
really
at my phone.
Sticking
my
it.
My phone's newer than yours, bitch.
Yeah, stick it to those white liberals, Tommy.
All right, here's another one. It's not beef, it's critique. Why can't black men just agree to disagree? Oh, yeah.
Oh, okay, wait a minute. We got to pause it already. Tommy Sotomayor, the guy that DMC'd our videos because he didn't like what we had to say about him, just put up a title screen that says, "It's not beef, it's critique."
I mean, I don't even care about his hypocrisy anymore. It's like whatever. It's, like, it's just you expect it. You just expect everything he says to be totally full of shit within like 2 seconds.
Wow. This looks like a much nicer pool too. Tommy, down for
this. This was a much nicer house.
Yep.
But he lost this one. And look how he feels the need to, like, show him approaching this and shit.
He's walking on, like, a balance beam.
Well, look, let's see the pool.
It's not even that thin. Dude, does Tommy's walk look kind of like...
Oompa Loompa-ish.
I mean, like, he looks like he's kind of struggling a little bit.
Yeah, he walks... He's not fat, but he walks like a fat guy.
Yeah, he's walking like... There's, like, a bunch... Like, maybe his knees are shit or something.
Yeah, maybe.
He walks like he's... Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
What's going on, everyone? It's your boy, Tommy Sotomayor. I want to ask you a question.
All right.
Why is it that we as black people can't agree to disagree?
Too bad there was no lady around to help you fix your fucking tie, Tommy. Your tie's all out of whack this whole fucking video.
Yeah, dude. I mean, like, you went through a lot of trouble to fucking, like, put on your nice purple
your
shirt
and
your
intro.
Fucking vest and do your, like, little, like, walk up to the camera intro, which was weird. Why did you even do that?
Oh, yeah.
But, you know, whatever. And then the tie is crooked, you know? You fucked it up, Tommy.
Yeah, you can see the button. The tie should cover all of the buttons, dude.
Yeah, like, all you gotta do is give it a tug. Maybe he's gonna correct it.
Why is it that we believe that there's only one... Is there's only room for one train of thought?
What? Who believes that?
Him.
Dude, Tommy,
I
need a script.
This question because I'm kind of curious. Because I believe a lot of problems we have...
This is awful. Black men.
I think the most of the time... Tommy's most of the like time dedicated to Tommy's videos is like camera angle and then like wardrobe, and that's it.
Oh, background of course too.
Yeah,
this preferably a pool.
Yeah,
he finds like the most obnoxious music. Like anyone, I don't like people playing music in the background of their videos generally. I mean, sometimes it's okay, but usually like 90% of the time is shit.
As like
he
an
just
accent,
always does it.
Like an accent.
And this one is just way, way overpowering for just a vlog.
He should be dancing.
More low-key.
He needs to be dancing in this video to like make up for it at this point.
Yeah, dude.
Is that it's not beef. It's mostly critique. Let me explain. See if I can get this down a little bit.
Oh my God.
So wait a minute. Wait a minute. So you took the time to take that pretentious douche walk up to the camera to show off how you got... I got a bridge in between my two pools that I can walk across. But you didn't fucking frame the shot before you started shooting. You gotta do that.
Not only that, it looks like he's making the shot worse.
Excuse my shaking hand.
Okay, I guess it's okay.
Move this up a little bit. I'm moving on the fly.
You just put the wire in the middle of the shot.
God, Tommy, you're so dumb.
What is that? There's some wire hanging in the shot now.
But it's not beef.
You fucked it up, Tommy. That
what
wire wasn't there,
retard.
Now it is. Tommy.
It ain't broke, don't fix it.
You're a fucking disaster.
It's mostly critique.
How could you not notice that?
See, if Crooked someone doesn't pie. Like what we do or like what we say.
The wire hanging in front of the camera lens?
At
I don't
the
know.
Very least, just clip it out of the fucking shot. Like, get yourself... Tommy, you always talk about how much money and shit you got. Get yourself a copy of fucking Premiere Pro for like fucking $15 a month.
It.
And you could just fucking crop that shit right the fuck out of there. Easy as pie, bitch.
Can we truly say that what it is that we did or said was 100% correct?
I mean, he has enough to put his, you know, his Twitter handle up there. You know? So, you know he ran this through some sort of editing software.
Yeah, like, I'm pretty sure Paul's right about it just being, like, movie maker, though.
Probably.
Oh, yeah, it is.
In order to grow, you'd assume there'd be room for different ideas. There'd be room for some coon ideas.
All right, like, Tommy,
for some
seriously.
Coon ideas.
Yeah, dude, there'd be room for some coon ideas.
The first Tommy. Thing I've heard him say in this video.
Tommy, I'm serious, dude. Stop spending all your money on fucking stupid clothes and pools and houses that are way too big for you to fucking even live in. Like, why does one man need a fucking house this big? He doesn't.
No.
It's got 7 bedrooms, y'all.
I mean, yeah, you're one person and you're living in a fucking, like, 7-bedroom house, probably a 5-bedroom house by now. But you're trying to, like, live, you're trying to look like you're living large and shit. Instead of spending all your money on that stupid shit, buy yourself a copy of fucking Premiere Pro and get some fucking lessons so you can actually edit a fucking video.
Room for some goon ideas. Room for a lot of ideas.
Coon and goon
ideas. The reason
I
say this is because I believe people are smart if you give them a choice. This is where propaganda comes in. America has flourished with propaganda. They understand that. Just make sure you don't give people a choice. You don't give people a choice. You push them to the choice that you want them to have. That's what America's done.
What are you talking about? I mean, people kind of have a herd mentality anyway. But if anything, America, that's less prominent than it is in other countries.
That's what a lot of you people have done.
You people.
You pro-blacks, you coons, you goons, whatever words you want to use to describe whatever it is you feel, whatever ideal you have. What you've done is try to effectively take out the other side or any opposing view. But if what you say is really good, then why would you fear having other people's opinion heard? Feels like it's going to rain a little bit, so I'm going to see if I can get this in really fast.
He's in Arizona, so if it rains, it's not going to rain that hard.
Thoughts about America?
Rarely.
There's a covered area right over there. You can still get his pool in the shot.
If it's monsoon season, it'll rain really hard. Super hard in Arizona.
Yeah, it'll rain really hard for like 20 minutes, basically.
Either way, you don't want your camera out in it.
True. You're right. You're correct about that. But monsoon season is like random, like hard rain.
There's a covered area right there, though. You could easily just be like, "Well, 1 second," and then just edit. You know, you just basically just edits the shot where now he's over
there.
Yeah,
but then I can't show off my fucking double decker pool that I don't own anymore because it got repossessed because I had to fucking ask for more money to get a smaller mansion on a shitty golf course.
Life, or just an amalgamation of me seeing things that I saw work. Things that didn't work, and then a bit of my own ideas.
TJ, it's you like the music, don't lie.
My thoughts, and I try to give it to other people.
It's higher in the mix people than his fucking vocals.
People have the ability to watch my videos and decide if it's good enough for them in their life. People also have the ability to...
Okay, like, here's what, no one's trying to silence you, all right? No one cares.
All right, next one. Yes, I am a coon and a sellout. Can pro-blacks answer this question? Part one. What?
Wow. Why does it need to be 15 minutes to ask a question? And this is only part one.
Oh, what a shocking angle.
What's going on, everyone?
Why is he so in love with shooting in front of his pool, dude?
He has a pool.
Because he desperately needs affirmation from people. He needs people to... He thinks that people are looking at these videos and going, look at Tommy, man. He really made it. But really, anybody that's been watching Tommy for longer than a fucking year knows that he no longer owns this pool because he can't afford these fucking places. So really what people are thinking is, what a fucking idiot who continuously leases out homes that he can't fucking pay for.
Hey, Paul. Hey, Paul, you got a pool?
I don't. Well, actually, I do. Yeah, I've got 3 pools.
Oh, you got 3 pools. Oh, yeah. So you own the pools. You own all those 3 pools.
Neither does Tommy.
No, man. Tommy fucking owns
Tommy
that
own
pool.
Tommy doesn't own these fucking pools.
Tommy owns this fucking pool, dude. Tommy has his pool. Does your pool have a fucking water slide?
I don't know. I haven't really looked at my pools yet. That's how fucking rich I am. I haven't even been to my pools yet.
Yeah, he's got a waterfall and a water slide, or he did.
Tommy and David Duke should just do a reality show together. You can call it Tommy.
Dude, they should just live together, man.
That's what I'm saying.
Live together at this fucking house.
Well, not this one, because this one's been taken away. But
yeah, well, you know what? They'll get funding, so they can live here again.
I bet you it hurts, Tommy, when you look at these old videos where you had that pool with a water slide. You ever just shake your head like, man, I missed that water slide.
Wasn't property in Arizona?
I never used it once.
Cheap as shit, too, though.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, so there you go. So this is probably like a $300,000 or $400,000 house in Arizona.
With a pool like that, easily, yeah.
It's your boy, Tommy Sotomayor. I had to cover up my taco meat because, you know, well, there's a certain Lip Smacking Mac who will probably...
Did you say cover up his taco meat?
Cover up my taco meat?
What does that mean?
I don't even know.
Man.
Is that a sexual innuendo?
What does that mean to play us out? You know, who the fuck knows what Tommy's saying half the time?
Look at it and go nuts. Because, well, he has a thing, an affinity for my taco meat. Not really sure what that means, but...
I'm not either.
I want to talk about this thing called a coon. It's well established now by anybody with any common sense, that I am, in fact, a coon. So now that we've established that I'm a coon, what else should we talk about? I want to talk about how it appears that it is very difficult to have a civilized, constructive conversation with pro-blacks. Over the last few days, they've been putting up videos
of mine from an interview
I did with Miss Tommy Lauren. Over the past few years, I've been putting up videos of my own with my own thoughts.
God, in the process, I feel like I'm staring into the void watching this much fucking Tommy Sotomayor. It's just unwatchably bad. Like, I'm trying to tune in to what he's saying, because I'm like, man, I got to find something else to say, because really, the pool is all I got on this one. And I can't fucking lock in on a single coherent thought that requires my comment.
You know, I would say...
you're drowning in that pool, dude.
I would say that, you know... Besides Canyon Trail, this is like the worst thing we've ever done.
Tommy's like an anchor around your...
Whatever, this is the greatest of all time.
No, this is definitely not even close to the most painful thing we've had to fucking sit through.
Here's another one. Tommy Sotomayor reveals he's been to jail and breaks down while explaining why.
All right.
Cool.
Cry, Tommy.
Poor Tommy.
Man, oh my God, Tommy is the Black Brett Keane.
Yep.
He is.
Putting up a look what at is this it? Weeping.
Does this mean that if Brett Keane was black, he'd be more successful?
Maybe.
Yes.
No one's touching
What's
that
up,
one.
What's up, everybody? I'm Thomas Sotomayor. You all know me as a YouTube personality, own internet radio show host, and
how many times you practice this one in front of this dude?
Philanthropist. Look, he's a philanthropist, guys.
I donate to Tommy Sotomayor Inc.
He has a real I like his real solemn voice. Well, hey guys, let's have a talk about something something I did in my life.
He donates to Tommy Sotomayor Films, which is going to make a movie about fatherless in America.
Hey, that's a charity, man. Come on.
A lot of y'all know me as a YouTube personality. YouTube stuff.
The Tommy charity. This is a sympathy
Philanthropist
charity.
Philanthropist genius.
There's something that a lot of people don't know about me.
Oh my God, what is it?
I'm a rapist.
I have been to jail.
Oh no.
Yeah, whatever.
I don't respect you anymore, Tommy, now that I found out you've been to jail.
Now I know.
But you didn't pay a traffic ticket?
No, I can finish this.
Shut up, Tom.
Oh, come on, dude.
Nobody else there.
Hey.
Oh, my God.
There's nobody else there.
Really?
No, I hope that's a joke. Let me tell my production assistant that adds the fucking shitty Windows Movie Maker titles to the end of my videos that I'm going to be okay. I'll make it through this one.
I know it's hard for many of you to believe that a black man has been in jail.
Okay, it's a joke.
I can be strong. I know that many of you cannot believe that a black man has been to jail. And I know that many of you stopped following and listening to black men after you found out they've been to jail. I mean, no one respects Malcolm X anymore. No one listens to me.
Oh, you're a Malcolm X again.
Yep.
Dude.
Wow. Cool.
He always places himself in very lofty company.
Malcolm X. Once they found out he went to jail. No one listens to Malcolm X and Martin Luther King once they find out he went to jail. I mean, people...
Yeah.
I see what happens to rappers' careers. Once rappers have admitted that they've been in jail, it's over. People just stop listening to the rappers. They don't... Black people just... If you...
The point, sir...
His point is that all these other people went to jail. Malcolm X, Martin Luther King, rappers. People still listen to them.
Yeah, I get it. So let's move on to whatever the next point... Is there a next point?
Well, this video is 15 minutes long.
I've been in jail. Black folks get mad about it. And I understand. That's why. I tried my best to keep this under wraps. Now, I know when I started doing my radio show 6 years ago, I actually talked about me being in jail and stuff like that. And I know
God, this is
my
so contrived.
Videos all chronicle that I've been in jail, but I was trying to hide and steal.
All of them chronicle that. All of them. Every single one chronicles his jail experience.
Hi, my name's Tommy Sotomayor. This here is my fucking pool, and I've been in jail. So let's talk about black women. No.
No, people like Tupac. People don't listen to Tupac anymore because they
feel you're
like
not Tupac. It, fact, shit.
We
fucking get it, Jesus
the fact
Christ.
That Rick Ross have never been in jail. What they do is they praise Rick Ross for not being in jail. They don't criticize him for actually not having a jail record. And I see how it works.
This is his response to, like, people...
Someone's trying to say, oh, he's been to jail, and yep. This is his, like, little sarcastic response yep. of, like, oh, yeah. You know, all these other people went to jail, so whatever, fuck you.
Because black people despise people that's been in jail.
Well, Martin Luther King went to jail for, like, civil disobedience.
Yeah, what did you go to jail for?
Yeah.
Was it civil disobedience?
I don't think it's... I don't think you were laying around in the street for civil rights when you got arrested. Don't think that happened. If I'm wrong, then I'll apologize for it, but somehow I don't think that's what was happening.
Who knows? Maybe he's going to tell us, dude.
I mean, no. Marion Barry.
Let's see if he actually does...
Once
it's
they
a
found out he went
to
jail
video.
For smoking crack, black folks did not elect him to 3 more terms.
I don't think people should go to jail for smoking crack, but I don't know if they should be
elected.
Yeah, elected.
Office.
Yeah.
Black folks. I know you guys want your voices and leaderships to be squeaky clean people. I mean, Christianity surely would have failed if Jesus had ever been arrested. No one would be Christian.
Oh my fucking God!
Jesus was arrested. Is he being? I don't even know where he's going with this.
What is he fucking?
Who knows with Tommy?
He's belaboring this shitty fucking.
The whole
point.
Like,
oh, come on, Tommy, get to the fucking point.
Christian. I mean, that's like one of the cornerstones of Christianity that Jesus was arrested and then executed. So, like, what do you mean? I don't get it.
If Jesus had ever been arrested,
Jesus was arrested. He was
just
fucking
spent
executed.
The last few minutes with some guy named Thomas and
you're
another
not
guy
Jesus.
Named Nat Turner.
Thomas and Nat Turner. Okay.
And gosh, Nat Turner was going off on me. He was letting me have it. He was telling me that I haven't done anything for black people. He was saying that what I'm doing is.
I don't get. Like, he compares himself to these, like, huge people that are like, I don't know.
Is going downhill and no
so
one
epic,
listens
dude.
To it
yeah.
anymore. And he's right. And so I asked Nat Turner, the revolutionary, of course. I asked Nat Turner after he asked me, he said, what have you done for black people? And I named all of the people. Well, I didn't name the people by name, but I named the people who would be willing to come and let him know that I've paid their bills. I have donated to their cause.
Tommy, you don't even pay your own fucking bills.
All right, next video.
It's fucking awful.
Typical Tommy fucking garbage.
I don't know if this ever actually happened, but this is Tommy Sotomayor's promo for his first movie role, Drugs and Other Love. And I looked up this movie and I could not find him on the cast of it, but it did come out last year. Maybe they cut his scene or something.
Let's see. Well, this movie looks like
shit. I'm Tommy Sotomayor, and I'm going to be in a new film called Drugs and Other Love. And I want you guys to go to drugsandotherlove.com, click on the Indiegogo link, and check us out. Because we got a funny cast of people, and it's going to be a great movie. So make sure you go there and support us.
Drugs and Other Love. Yeah, they look like a real wacky group.
Looks great, dude. Looks awesome. Man. Basically, Tommy was involved in another scam to raise money. Okay, so great.
Take my money, please.
The movie did come out, though, but I went to the IMDb for it, and I don't see his name on it anywhere.
Well, after that, after he saw them making those silly faces, he beat the shit out of them, and they kicked him off the production.
Maybe somebody decided to look into Tommy Sotomayor's fucking videos and decided maybe having his name attached to this project would not be a good thing.
Maybe they just had him in a scene so that they could use his channel to fundraise their movie.
Probably.
All right, this is Tommy Sotomayor is supported by white supremacist. Let's boycott him along with these racist
thin something.
Yeah.
I don't know. Let's see.
Yeah, drop that bass.
What's going on, everyone? It's your boy, Tommy Sotomayor. I'm coming at you because I want to address an issue that's been brought to me, and I figured the best way to do these things is to address them intellectually.
Damn, he made a t-shirt for his movie, but he never actually made the movie. Well, the t-shirt's easy. That's great.
You made movie-less t-shirt.
You made t-shirts for a movie that never happened. That's awesome.
A movie-less t-shirt, dude. We should make a Tommy Sotomayor t-shirt that just, you know, it says a movie-less t-shirt on it.
Yeah, dude. Or we could just make Fatherless America, dude.
Well, if you ask the things...
Maybe we could just title this video A Fatherless America, Tommy Sotomayor. Drunken Peasants special episode.
Emotionally, you may not get where you want to get, but if you answer them intellectually... The least they can say is you answered it, and however they take it after that is fine, but they can't say you emotionally whatever, or you yelled at them, you cussed at them, or you didn't answer them at all. They can't say any of that.
Tommy, I was thinking, since I have a million subscribers now, or I'm pretty close, I'm kind of wanting to add shitty background music to all my videos that distracts from what I'm saying. Could you give me a URL where I could download this?
What do you mean distract? You mean this like 90s hip hop beat with the is like distracting to what he's saying?
He does like he does everything wrong.
How does he have this huge level audience?
Incompetence? I don't get it.
He has a huge audience.
Like, the more I watch, the more I'm just like, how?
Well, I got an email from a guy, and the guy said, he said, hey, this dude did a video and said that your video was on a racist website.
I can't listen to this shitty music.
The racists are supporting
you. Oh, dude. Said, late. TJ, you're sure so enough, close.
Your video was there on this.
Oh, no, you did it, dude.
Yeah.
You did it.
Woo!
God.
Wow, this is TJ's initial reaction, actually.
Yeah, dude.
To seeing that he has over a million subscribers.
One million idiots. It could go back down again, TJ. See, they're trying to.
This isn't live, though, and this is like the pay-per-view program anyway. So there you go. Congratulations, TJ. That's
nice,
awesome.
Dude.
Yeah, bitch. You get the gold awesome. Play button, dude.
Yeah, where's my gold? I'm going to sell it on eBay.
You're an idiot.
But the guy was trying to prove that since your video is on there, that's why everybody should be banning you. What are your thoughts on that? And so I looked at it and I said, well, one, I didn't know that my videos was on some racist websites because the racists have not reached out to me and said, hey, could you speak on our behalf? We'd like to pay you to come do a tour and speak on our behalf.
No, you just do it for free.
Yeah, maybe they didn't pay you, but...
Well, he doesn't do it for free. He just launched his GoFundMes.
I'm pretty sure David Duke didn't pay him.
No.
But I didn't hear him raise any issues of contention with David Duke at all. Like, it was a pretty softball kind of interview.
Yes, sir, Mr. Duke. I do believe that niggas are inferior to every other race. Oh, yes, sir, Mr. Duke. I sure do believe that all our problems are our own, Mr. Duke.
Oh, Mr. Duke.
Tommy, your views on black people have helped us go out and be racist, because before we were thinking about not being racist, but now that your videos have come out, we're now more racist. Here's the thing. If my video was on a racist website, shouldn't the people attack the website, not me? Because if the there's a racist website, and that website is using my video, for what, I don't know, because when I watched it seemed like the guys were all insane.
Why do you think they're using your video? Just if you had to venture a guess as to, you know, why is this racist website using my video?
I wonder why these racist white people are interested in my new video, Fuck Niggers and Everything About Them.
You know,
featuring David Duke.
Featuring David Duke, man. Why are these white racists coming around my videos?
I don't get it.
Hey, well, this guy has some points. He's one of the few black guys that's actually talking about whatever it is.
You're like a girl with huge tits that just rubs honey on them every video. And it's like, wow, these horny men coming to my videos.
Shit, dude. Hold on. Oh, dude, let me play this video for you since you just said that. Hold on.
All right, guys, this is a mandatory titty break. A girl named Alexa Cave sent me this video via Twitter. She said, I know you like breasts. Take a look at this.
TJ's like, yeah.
Well, guys, like, yeah. Here's what she
we deserve this after sitting through so much time.
The best part of the video.
He said, Brazilian.
Wow, even the titty video that he chooses to show is annoying and unsexy and unwatchable and unappealing in every way.
Oh, I don't know. God. I still like them titties, dude. But
I mean, they were some nice titties. But
what
I
was
mean,
with the screeching?
Yeah, the screeching. It's a terrible video.
I can go anywhere else.
Looks like a high school classroom, too.
I can go anywhere on the internet and see a big fat pair of fucking titties without a pterodactyl screech in the background.
If there's ever been a part for him to play his music over something, it's this.
Yeah.
Okay. Hmm. Yeah, this is not that great.
Oh, yeah, it is.
Let's hear what he says about
it. It's like bowling balls, dude.
TJ's impressed.
She's like, oh, it's a great, great video.
She going, yeah. Yeah, take it off. Whatever? Yeah, there's... whatever. Gotcha.
Okay.
She's showing that there's no, like, surgery mark, I guess.
Yeah.
Yeah, take them on out, baby.
She's like, yeah, this video getting better by the second. Why is there yelling and screeching?
Why are they... what is... why?
Yeah, why do you have to... ah! Like, every 3 seconds.
This is why women are horrible, dude.
Dude, women in groups, man.
Why do they have to screech?
Yeah.
Don't screech. Don't do that.
Dude, what was it, your Instagram or something that you posted? Like, I hate these bitches or something in Seattle when you were, like, visiting.
Oh, yeah, those bitches.
Like, but, you know, like, there's been so many times I've been places, and if there's a large group of women, like, at least three, it's just, like, the place just gets so fucking loud.
You know what?
Myself, I'm acting like an animal.
And then the next day, I saw, there was, like, this group of 3 dudes who are basically like the male equivalent of those girls.
Oh, God.
So, like, one day I was like, oh my God! And then the next day I went out to look.
Dude, you know,
it's like, fuck. Kill these people.
Can't escape it, man.
Now, here's my scandal. I want to get you home and double up.
What is happening? Tommy, just stop, dude. Just stop. You cannot pull that off. Tommy, you might be able to pull that off if you're actually motorboating a pair of titties. Like, maybe I would give it to you, man, but no.
Look at this.
Just stop, man. Just stop, dude.
Good Lord Jesus, them titties on that girl. Goodness. Make me want to enroll, become a damn career.
This is the most excited I've ever seen him.
Yeah.
Because usually he's like, I'm Tommy Sotomayor, you know, fuck black bitches, and that's it. Anyway, give me some money. I'm making a movie or whatever. I don't know.
Or whatever.
Fatherless
American. College student. Good night. Now, I will say this. For some reason, when you get a girl with some nice big old titties like that, they got a shitty shape. No ass, and this girl's a young girl. She gonna be fat like a son of a bitch when she get old. But good Lord, right now, I just fall into them titties. Like the titties was...
She gonna be shit. In a few years, she gonna be nasty, but now she looking good.
Not like Tommy. Tommy's like fine wine.
Why
man.
Would anyone... Like, why would any woman like you? I'm just like, you're horrible.
Bitch, in about 10 you're years, just, you're gonna be nasty.
Like, you're just a wretched, disgusting piece of shit. Like, I've watched all these videos, and I've literally been searching for some redeeming characteristic, and there's none. You're just awful. You're an awful fucking person. Anybody who supports you is awful. You're the worst fucking thing I've ever seen. You mean like, we're gonna do one of these episodes. Assuming this one's a success, we're probably gonna do one of these of Brett Keane and have to sit here and watch two fucking hours of Brett Keane. So I'm sure that'll be even worse. But you're pretty fucking bad.
Here's an interesting title: Tommy Sotomayor suffers a slight heart attack. See how he changed his health and outlook.
Wow, and only he's like, let me walk really far.
At least he's playing. This is like his favorite beat that he plays in the background.
It's kind of jazzy.
What's going on, everyone? It's your boy Tommy Sotomayor. I want to talk to you about what happened to me yesterday and what's going to happen going forward.
Oh, shit, what happened, man?
Yesterday I did a show. One of the first time I did a two-part show where. First half, I talked about one thing, which was gospel entertainers and singers, should they be held to a moral standard, or are they just entertainers?
They're entertainers.
The second half of the show, what we talked about was racism in professional sports. And each one was riveting. Matter of fact, I'll put
what?
The video...
riveting.
It was riveting.
Tommy,
content.
I've seen... We've sat through how many of your videos now? I don't even know. But,
nothing about you is riveting.
The word riveting... Like, unless you're talking about, like, no, there's nothing.
Dude, Tommy is the antithesis of fucking riveting. Tommy has never made a riveting video. Like, all his videos are just kind of like, hey, guys, I'm standing in front of somewhere in my house bullshitting about, you know, black women and how much I hate them and how they're destroying the world.
I mean, like,
how they're basically fucking velociraptors seeking you out for fucking certain doom. Come on.
You mean, like, Tommy, even if you made a video of you, like... putting actual rivets into a fucking boat or something, it still wouldn't be riveting. You're horrible.
Links inside of the description box. Each one had over 150 calls, because that's all I can accept is 150 calls, and then what happens is it you can't call in. People were emailing saying they can't get in, they want to talk. Which typically happens on every one of the shows.
Of course.
I have celebrity friends who hit me up and say, how do you entertain
celebrity
so
friends?
All right,
what are their names? Name one of them, please.
Buddy of mine. I got a buddy of mine. Let me tell you guys. I got a buddy of mine. He has the fucking craziest monster truck you've ever seen. What's his name? Oh, just a buddy of mine.
Show was 6.5 hours long, and it would have been 7.
Hey, we had an uncle like that. He was always telling these crazy
about
stories
buddy
about
of his?
Buddy of mine. Buddy of mine did this. Buddy of mine, blah, 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 blah. And you'd be like, who's his buddy's name? Oh, you know, just a buddy of mine.
Well, dude, I remember, like, one time we were talking about motorcycles, and I'm like, man, that Ducati motorcycle in that movie Tron, like, the movie sucks, but that motorcycle is awesome. And he's all like, yeah, buddy of mine owned a Ducati. Yeah, it ain't really nothing. I rode around all the time. Actually, you know, this bike is better. It's like, no, you didn't, dude. You didn't ride, like, an $90,000 bike around town. Your buddy didn't just lend you his fucking expensive Italian-made motorcycle.
Yeah. It wasn't all that. I mean, I know that it's, like, the finest engineering in the world and shit, but, you know, it wasn't all that. It was shit.
7 hours had I not stopped because the system shut down.
Kawasaki better.
We continue to
crotch
have
rocket,
this discussion.
Crotch rocket, motherfucker.
And
crotch rocket.
Everybody seemed to have fun, which is what happens on most of my shows. You don't have shows full of contention. I don't want shows
what?
Full of contention. I don't want a website full of contention. I don't
You thrive on contention. If that contention, if you remove contention, Tommy, there's not much of you left.
I mean, like... This is like if I just came out my videos and was constantly talking about how, like, You know, I don't like being mean to people. I don't like talking no shit against anybody.
I don't like arguing.
I try to be nice to people as much as I can. I'm always just like the greatest guy. You know, I don't ever take no one apart. I'm very tolerant of other people's opinions and shit. Like, no, you're not. I'm not. What kind of lies are you fucking telling yourself? You're the one of the most contentious motherfuckers ever.
Wouldn't you say that...
You don't even agree with your fucking self. That's how contentious you are.
As painful as this was, it does, like... Anyone who watches this will understand how much of a huckster Tommy Sotomayor is after this.
Oh, yeah, dude. Anybody who's watched this with us, anybody who's made this journey through the depths of Tommy Sotomayor with us... Is totally on the same page with us.
No, I agree with you. No one should be Fatherless America. This is as close as you'll ever come to seeing Fatherless America is this.
No one is going to write to us and be like, you guys were unfair to Tommy. No, that's not going to happen. Like,
no.
Like, literally, I've tried to find something to like about him. I've tried. It's not there.
I'm pretty sure he'll say something about this, too. Probably like, these white liberals just obsessed with me.
They're making money off my name.
Yeah, they're just making money off me. They're obsessed with me, man.
Well, that's the whole point. That's the whole reason we did this.
Yeah, because he made money off of us.
Yeah, so, fuck you, Tommy.
Yeah, fuck you, Tommy. The
I
saw
my Facebook page a bunch of people arguing, which is why I block people, which is why people complain and say, he blocked me. I don't understand. I don't want a bunch of argument. I don't wake up... I'm not like you guys, Housewives of Atlanta watchers. I don't wake up trying to infuse myself in some kind of drama.
Yes, you do.
When you watch how I do my news stories, I try my best to bring in humor into them, even when they are some of the most
tragic. What has there been any levity in you, dude? You're such a fucking, like, cynical, pessimistic, fucking down on everyone motherfucker. Like,
I can't think of a single joke that you've made in all the videos we've watched.
Nope.
Like, the closest thing you've come to a joke is, like...
It's his fucking life,
like,
dude.
You'll fake some sarcasm every now and then. You'll be like, I'm being sarcastic right now. That's, like, the extent of your humor is, like, I'm gonna sarcastically cry and act like this is a bigger deal than it is. Because that'll be, like, a comedic exaggeration.
Yeah,
but that's about it.
Not at all funny.
I've never seen you crack a joke. I've never seen you say anything designed to be funny.
His manner of speaking... without saying anything just makes me want to pull my fucking hair out. Like, hearing it back to back like this, and every new video, like, whenever Ben starts a new video, I get excited because I'm like, okay, this one will have something. Like, it's like Pavlov. Like, I can't learn, you know, like, I don't understand him. I don't know what he's talking about in this video, despite really trying to follow it. Because he just meanders and rambles repeats.
If we're watching a Gale video, I would take more away from that than I would take away from anything Tommy has said. Like, you know, batshit crazy people, like, what are they saying? Oh, okay, they're just saying some crazy bullshit. What is Tommy saying? Like, a whole lot of fucking nothing.
Stories that you could ever think of. Well, after that 6.5-hour show, I was looking up some things...
What, a 6.5-hour show?
Dude, he is the Black Brett Keane. Come on.
Jesus.
We're just going to call him Black Keane from now on.
Like, I could hardly handle a 4-hour show. A 6.5-hour show. I mean, like, I'm used to 2.5. But, like, what?
I think the longest Drunken Peasants we ever did was 4.5 hours.
Sure.
And Ben was, like, beyond
wasted.
That's
because Ben was wasted.
Well, I think we've done private shows that were longer, right? Or was that still the longest one?
No, that 4.5-hour one.
I don't think we've ever breached the 5-hour mark.
We should try to set a record eventually, like one of these nights in the studio.
Episode 300, dude.
It should be so fucking epic.
We should party all night long.
Crazy.
Yeah, we could even just keep our webcams going if we're just tired of, like, actually talking.
Of us sleeping.
Yeah, we'll just have us fucking, like, smoking weed or some shit in the background.
Yeah. Sweet. Episode 300.
So I think this is... We've done enough of this, right? This is
2 hours. More, TJ.
I'd say
more.
Trying to see exactly how I want to do one more video. One more video. To finish it off. What shall it be?
Fine.
Why mixed people should not be called black, I think we kind of already covered that.
We've kind of already covered everything Tommy talks about.
Dear Michael Jordan, please don't marry that chick, and here's why.
Okay. Of course.
Dear Michael Jordan, you don't know me, but I'm a radio show host here in Atlanta.
Small, yes, I know. But small, my name is modest. Tommy Sotomayor. And I did a report on the young man who was on YouTube saying that he was your son. And I defended you. Yes, I did. I am one of your biggest fans.
I want to point out that Tommy doesn't know how to fake write.
It sounds like a love letter.
Look,
so
he's
far.
He's not moving the pen. He's just dragging it across as he talks. Like, he's not pretending to even scribble. Like, do some scribbles. Make it look like the pen's actually moving around.
Even if you want to fuck up a perfectly good piece of paper.
Dude, even if you actually have to write the fucking letter that you're narrating, you know, that you're doing the voiceover for, like, so be it. Just make it look fucking authentic.
Tommy couldn't write that fast.
I used to be a huge Michael Jordan fan right after I realized that Dominique Wilkins sucked and couldn't dribble a damn ball or shoot.
You're right, dude. He's just dragging along.
At that moment, I realized. What?
Paul looks how I feel, dude.
I just fucking, like, I. This video, I was like, man, at least he's got a topic. He's got a topic, and he's going to get to it. Like, no. Something about Michael Jordan. Okay, I'm with it. Let's do it. It's just this shit. It's just.
Dude, that's Tommy. Come on. We've seen, like, fucking 15 Tommy videos at least. Like, or, like, I don't even know how many we've watched, but God, like, this is just. Tommy is incapable of actually having a point. He doesn't have a point. He says one of his tropes that he runs back to, you know, like, black people are just destroying themselves. Black women are evil.
Why not be a fan of the team that wins all the fucking time? And that team was the Chicago Bulls. So I immediately became a fan of yours. Now, I must admit, wasn't a big fan of Space Jam because it was fucking stupid, but...
Well, at least I agree with him on that.
You know, let's be honest. Like, I mean, if you... Let's say you even actually wrote this letter to Michael Jordan. Like, Michael Jordan would take the time to read fucking Tommy Sotomayor's fucking retarded letter. Like, oh, Mr. Jordan, you know, here's this letter from one of your fans. He'd probably look at him like they're crazy. I'm like, throw that shit in the fire. You know, like, I'm busy.
That is neither here nor there. I also am a big fan of your...
That's going to be another good title for this video. That is neither here nor there.
Yeah, neither here nor there. Yeah.
Yes, you write a fan letter. Dear TJ, you know, you're a pretty good guy. I like some of your garage videos, but every video you've done after that is fucking shit and you fucking suck. But that's neither here nor there.
Shoes, although that they cost about 50 cents to make and you charge people about $200 to $300 for them, and
they
black
cost more
people
than 50
are killing
cents.
Themselves over your shoes and you don't say a word, but that's not your fault.
Why would you? What are you supposed to do? Come out and be like, hey guys, don't be as excited about my product, y'all. That's dumb.
Well, that's what Tommy does, though. See, he's projecting. Because what Tommy does is he raises a bunch of money for a product and then instantly wants everybody to forget about it. So that
at
he
least
can
you get the shoes.
Yeah, least, I mean, at least with so Michael Jordan. Yeah, Michael Jordan shoes, might dude. Be ripping you off, but at least you get a pair of fucking sneakers out of the deal.
Yep.
Or you go through a $200 million divorce with your last wife, and that hurt my pockets, even though if I got married, a woman couldn't get $200 out of me. But that goes to the point of this whole letter that I'm writing.
Why couldn't they get $200 out of you? It's because you don't have it?
I think they've already gotten $200 out of Tommy before.
I mean,
far more than
Or is it just
that.
Because you're so clever that no woman could ever beat you in court? I think the fact that you've had to move like three times since this kind of, you know,
maybe.
Well, I looked up Tommy Sotomayor's criminal record, and I can tell you that women have beat him in court from looking at what I'm looking at.
Oh, really?
One of his pinches is for non-payment of child support and like whatever they call it. Fuck. I had it up here and now it's gone, but it was like non-payment of child support and contempt of court. And then there were two simple battery charges and a violation of a restraining order. So,
oh, wow.
Yeah.
Nice.
I saw a photo. And I'll show the photo here. Of you getting a ring. And I saw it on TMZ. And it said you were applying for a marriage license. Now, I am a person who am understanding of marriage. Marriage seems like it would be fun. And you are marrying your longtime girlfriend, Yvette Prieto. I don't know how to say her name. But Michael Jeffrey.
Why would you need to know how to say it? You're writing it.
Not only that, how's any of your fucking business who Michael Jordan chooses to marry or not? Like, what relevance are you in that equation? Like, someone I don't know,
you know,
is doing
let's
something.
Let's go back. Let's revisit an earlier Tommy video and be like, you just saying that shit to Michael Jordan because you too broke to marry that bitch, Tommy. Oh. Why you broke niggas always trying to make everyone act broke, huh, Tommy?
Yeah, Michael Jordan's trying like a billionaire.
Trying to make put down your edicts on fucking Michael Jordan.
He wants to buy a $100,000 ring. He'll do it. He's rich.
He rich, bitch.
You're getting married, and you applied for a license in Jupiter, Florida, Palm Beach County.
Okay.
And it's great. But
it's great.
Here's my only issue.
Mike, what issue could you have with it?
You got money.
Yep.
See,
he does.
As for me, I'm a broke-ass dude. And broke-ass dudes, we can get married every damn week. See, there's really nothing that
I mean, just another fucking contradiction in the Tommy Sotomayor saga. Are you broke or are you rich, Tommy?
Yeah, which one is it?
Which one is it? Seems like you're alternately broke and rich in between big projects.
Alternately racist, victim of racism.
Here's the thing, like, TJ offered to go and talk to Tommy. Tommy fucking ducked TJ, so it's like, there's no, that's the thing about Tommy. Like, if you talk to him and point out all these contradictions, then he would actually have to defend it. He's not going to do that. He pretty much absolutely refuses to address any sort of criticism that's levied against him besides, like, cherry-picked shit, like, you know, like feminists, where it's like, look at this this guy that said they want to punch me in the face. All men are violent, you know? That's all Tommy does.
Yeah, he's a pussy. Like, he's a clear pussy. He uses the tool of the pussy, the DMCA, to silence people. He's a pussy, for sure.
Yeah.
Nobody's disputing that.
Okay, it's over.
It's done.
We're done.
All right, we're done.
Any last words, like, anything you want to say?
Final thoughts.
I'm finally glad it's
over.
Ben,
do you have any final thoughts on Tommy?
I mean, I definitely want to watch a Tommy video tonight when we actually do the show. Because for anyone who's watching.
Just to see our reaction.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, God.
Don't tempt me. I'm tempted now. But... yeah, for those of you who don't know, we're doing a regular show in a few hours, too.
Yeah.
Sweet!
I feel dead after my final thoughts are that Tommy is... like, I mean, I kind of already gave him, but he's not likable.
You tried to talk to him and everything.
Yeah, I mean, like, he's not a likable person. He's just really wretched. He's really self-concerned.
He's a coward.
He's totally oblivious to his own hypocrisy. Either that or he just doesn't care about it. He really does, the more we watch him, remind me of just Brett Keane. He just is like a black Brett Keane, who is actually a little bit more successful at the scam.
He's way more successful.
He's just a fucking scammer. Like, I think the essence of Tommy is, it's all about Tommy, and it's all about him getting what he wants, and he doesn't give a shit about exploiting people to get that.
All right. Paul?
Yeah, no, I have nothing to add.
There really is nothing to add.
No. I mean, you guys said it all and then some.
All right. Thanks for watching, everyone. Spread the word on how much you enjoyed this. Let everyone know.
Fuck you, Tommy.
We're making it very affordable for everyone to watch. All right. Good night.